Okay, hello everyone, welcome back. All modifications are good. Yes, they are. All right. Well, hello, hello, hello. Welcome to literally sitting back and we talk good, which I'm already failing at. Let me know how the volume is for the stream. Stream health is dying. It's like the minute I talk, stream health decided, nah. Nah, too much work. Is it fine now? Did it finally chill? Alright, okay. that was a little bit of like, no, I'm okay. Oh, hello, welcome everybody. Hello, hello, hello. How's the music volume for the thingy? I specifically picked this one because it has one of the songs is titled, let's just say it's titled after a very lovable tank that we recently met. So, you'll know how that goes. But anyways though, this week's schedule is updated. Everything is good to go. Like I said, that this weekend coming up is going to be on a Sunday instead of a Saturday. I have something to do on a Saturday, so Sunday stream will happen for this coming week, so a heads up about that. Besides that, everything else is pretty good. But anyways, I'm here! Alright, there we go. Also, There we go. Alright. Hello, everybody! Hello, hello, hello! How's everybody been? Hello, Nako-chan, all around, man. Hello, Kori was here. Hello, Arson. Welcome. How has everybody been? How's March? I feel like, especially with the Persona streams, we were able to kind of talk pretty good. You know, we talk real good during those streams, but like, besides that, I don't know, it just feels like March. I just haven't had a long time to talk to you guys. I don't know, it's just not right at all. Also, why is my chat showing top chat? I want live chat. Give me the good stuff. Why is there different options, right? What is top chat? Some messages such as potential spam may not be visible. Why would I not want to see that? You know, to moderate my own. I don't know, that doesn't make sense. Anyways, Victor Fox, welcome back. Yes, long time no see. I see you again. Hello. Found a song called. No, I didn't find a song called, you know, Tank. It's to do with Tank-chan, I will say. Those of you that are not watching the Persona streams are probably like, what the heck is she talking about? But how's everybody been? How's No, don't do it. No. Make me change it to live chat. I get confused. What is it called? Top chat. That's weird. It's called top chat. Also, there's a new one. It says fan funding. Only if I want to see the fan funding ones. Interesting. But yeah, how's March been? March been pretty hectic, making you tired, making you dreading the rest of the year. Making you sad. Allergies for some. It's been really windy here, like extremely windy. It's been really, really bad windy. I don't like it. When I was in Japan, it was windy. And then now when I came back, it was windy again. I'm like, why? It was not windy when I left. What happened? Ugh, I don't like it. Also, yeah, I forgot. So, I have a funny story about that. So, my mother is always checking the channel and everything, helping on, seeing what's happening, right? Well, she's been watching the subscriber count. She's been waiting for 2K. She wants to take like the screenshots for all the milestones. I love my mother. She's amazing. I was spending time with her and everything, and I don't usually go see movies or anything. I don't like to go to the movie theaters, but she wanted to go to the movie theaters, so I was like, okay, alright, we'll go. And plus, it was one of the films I had been like, pretty excited to watch, so I was like, okay, it'll be pretty cool. So, went, everything, all good, and we were heading out, And I saw somebody that is likes to talk about my channel to me and everything, so they were talking about it and mentioned it, and I was like, that reminds me, I should probably check if that short had gone up and everything. And I saw it, and I saw that it was like way past the 2K, and I was like, oh. So, but I told my mother about it. She was very sad. You guys just made it just go yunk. So it was pretty funny. Just completely, you know, just missed the milestone by, you know, just not paying attention and all that. And my poor mother was so sad about it. Because you know how it says like the 2.0, I guess now it says 9 and all that. She had wanted to catch him. This is the 2.00. So she's like, no. but yeah. Red movies, money, probably puppies, definitely.
I love puppies. Wait, I love puppies. I love puppies. I have puppies. I own them.
They're not with me currently. I don't know where they went. I don't know where my little bonbon went, but I love puppies, okay? I love them. Dogs are amazing. Money's good too. But bread and movies, I can, yes, you're right about that. I don't like bread, and I don't like movies. I don't like movies, okay? Okay, I don't like the idea that I have to sit there and just watch. I don't know. Especially like, I don't know what it is. Like, especially like movies that are made by Hollywood. That's all that could come to mind. Like, movies that are made by just the Hollywood, I guess. They're just so predictable to me. And I don't like stuff that's pretty predictable. I don't. If it's like an adaptation of a book or something that I've read, then I enjoy that. Even though I kind of know how it's going to go and everything, I like seeing it, like, on the screen and not based off something I imagined, right? I imagined, but, you know, the book, creating the scenarios in your head. But anytime, like, it's just like a movie and I already know what's going to happen. Literally, I only can go to watch that movie because I was so excited to see a fight scene. So I was excited for that. I was very, very excited. There was one thing I was so excited for and I was like, yes! But that was literally it. That was literally it. And the popcorn. I like the popcorn. It was delicious. But other than that, it was, you know, it's okay. And then the idea of having to basically sit there and watch. Okay, yeah, that's the other thing. You guys know me. I can't sit still and not do multiple things at once. Like, even right now, I'm, like, moving the microphone constantly, which is not a good idea. But I don't like having to just sit there and, you know, being forced to only just watch. And, like, I can't have my phone on. It's too dark to read a book at the same time. I can't listen to something else because this is, like, it's supposed to be the whole idea of just sitting in one spot and just doing one single thing. Yes, it drives me nuts. It really, really does. I don't like this. Hello, welcome, Lord. No, hello, and welcome, Tim Tabai. Welcome. Where's it? Didn't really help her in the algorithm. I remember when my cousins were asking me about the shorts and everything. They're like, well, why don't you just make like videos just for like shorts, right? Like just record your own stuff. And I was like, no. One, I'd never keep up with it. I never would. And two, I don't know, I just like the idea of just capturing, like, little funny moments that we've had within the stream and just, like, how would you say? Not expanding on it, but, you know, just making it funnier. And a good time just to look at it and be like, ha! That moment kind of idea. I don't know. I like the idea of shorts being in that way of just capturing content that I've already done and just editing it and stuff like that, and just good old funny times and rage times too. That happens. Thank you, Lord. I appreciate it. And also, thank you guys. Thank you. Yeah, no, I was shocked too when I saw the 2K, and especially already, that's, what, the 90 mark or something like that? It was like, No. No. Only still images, please. Oh, I didn't show you guys what my desktop is right now. Hold on. Let me show you what desktop is. Just learning to hide my chat so it doesn't block it. All right, ready? 3, 2. Okay, I will give you guys a warning. This one scared the daylights out of me. I was sitting here and I was editing one of the shorts and everything, and this just came, like, it just changed right then and there, and it terrified me because it came out of nowhere. So ready? Here's what I saw. That thing. You see it? That thing. It just, out of nowhere, it was just poof, and then this was just staring at me. It's the worst. Also, I don't know if anybody's noticing something moving on my screen. I'm trying to figure out how to capture it onto the other screen, but I can't. It's refusing to. I need to figure out how the heck I need to do it. But yeah, if you don't know, basically, let's see if I can find a link for it and everything, but it's called Desktop Tale or something. It's kind of funny because actually one of my relatives was like, "Hey, didn't you like this Undertale Yellow game?" And I'm like, "Yeah." And then they showed it to me. But yeah, it's here. Moving around everything. You can control her and everything, but I just have her moving around idly, so. Hey, little martlet on my screen. Anyways. There you go. But yeah, that bird just scared the daylights out of me, like, so bad. It really did. I was just editing, and I was like, all right, put it there, and then ding, I was like, oh my god, they see it, judging me, thank you. Yeah, I'm gonna put the link in the description. I need to find where I got the link from. Check it through here. Hold on. I think I got it through this one. So many different web browsers, I'm like, I can't remember where I got it. It's literally this. Okay, so this is the thing. So you can go ahead and download it here and everything. Don't worry, it's fine. It's not a virus or anything. I double checked it. So it's under Desktop Tale. That's what it's called. So there you go. It should be in the description right now. But yeah. It's a little fun thing. I'm trying to figure out how to get it to capture it on the screen so you guys can see her moving around there, but all fun, all good on that. So she's moving around on my screen that I can see. You know what I can do, actually? Why not? Let's change things up. Why not? Let's change things up. You guys can see my chat here through too, so let's change things up, shall we? Let's change them up. Let me put them over to the side so we can see them again. There we go. Let's change things up. We're gonna watch through my desktop. How about that? All right. We'll do it this way. The bird is over there in the corner, but that's fine. We'll do it this way. We'll make this chatting stream a little different. You know, spice things up. I don't know why Marla's hiding in the up there, but she is. I don't know why, but she is. It's fine. Okay, let me move myself over here. There we go. Yeah, let's change things up a little bit for now, right? Marla's just... she's hiding, though. She's... Get back down here, please. There we go. Only thing is, if she hides behind me, she won't be walking on my face, so go up there. Alright. So where is the link? It should be in the description. It should have gotten updated. Also, Stream Health is having hiccups here and there. I don't know why. But it is. I think it's a mistake. It's okay, I'm covering the bird with you guys. It's fine, don't worry about it. Also, my mouse is on the screen. There we go. Don't worry about it. I never kept up with the Undertale remixes. From Undertale Yellow, which is a fantastic game. If there's any Undertale game I would ever recommend, it's literally the only fan game I've ever played, but I like it a lot. It's really, really good. One I would definitely recommend. Not a bear. Newest computer machine. Oh yeah, that's right. For those of you that haven't been here for quite a bit of time, streaming should be in 1080 quality, very least. I think it is. It should be based on all the settings I've done and everything. new computer and everything, and able to play games on the same computer, which is very nice, and not losing quality within the capture card, and also, you know, just actually able to run games properly. That, honestly, that was just a very... I've been wanting to upgrade my PC forever. Ever since I first started, I was like, I'm gonna upgrade it. I need to upgrade it. It needs to be. I finally got it, so hey, helps out a lot. Really helps out a lot. Except I don't know what's wrong with my background. It keeps changing. It just decided one day. He's like, no, you know, default background? Meh. I like to change now. A good old background jump scare. It did. It really, really did. The stream is chatting. I mean, that's good, but also my stream health for some reason keeps collapsing, so it's going to be separated because of that, so just a heads up. I don't know what's happening. Internet's being a pain. It's also weekend, so it's like, hey! Hey! So, yeah. Like a real streamer, almost. I still got a broken mouse, terrible keyboard. Still headphones that still semi-work. It's fine, it's all good. It's all good, it's all good. My family is coming to Japan really tomorrow. Anything you found surprising that I can help them with? Anything you found surprising I could help them with? What do you mean surprising? What do you mean? What do you mean by that? Not so be nice if the stream helped with, you know, stop it. Stop being in the red mark. I am begging you to stop being in the red mark! And also the terrible internet still. What is happening? I know it's the weekend, I know we've been having terrible weather, but like, please! You were fine literally the day before, and the day before was terrible. God, it was so bad. And then there he goes, this is nice to be like, okay, no, no, no. Hello Eric, welcome! What if it's this one? Oh yeah, for those of you that celebrate Easter, it's gonna be Easter, that's right, I kind of forgot about that. Kind of forgot, it's just... Oh, it's like all the days have been blending, they have, they've been just like one after another and after another, it's like... I forgot about that, but it's gonna be so great. Also milk, that's right, milk. Broken mouse, not the scroll wheel again, it's the same one! The same one, same old broken scroll wheel. It's fine, it still functions. It still works. Just takes me a second to get the items, but that's fine. It's normal, you know. A little bit of issues. The things you weren't expecting are found tough to understand. See, it's not my first time that I've been to Japan. It was my second time. Yeah, it was my second time I've been to Japan, so I kind of already knew things that were going around, and then the person, my uncle that I was with, so literally, like, I think it's fifth or sixth time since he was there, so, yeah, I can't really say that there was really anything shocking. Anything that it was like, whew. I mean, obviously, the subway systems were just having to get used to that and everything. Where I live, we don't really have subway systems. It's a small place. Just, it's like, hey, kind of idea. So, I think that would probably just be it. It's honestly the only thing. All I think was just tough was just the subway systems, but we got used to them after like a day or so, so it was just probably that. Look, mouse wheel has been with me since, I don't know how old this mouse wheel is. It was like a cheap gaming mouse. Like, it has the side, like, the buttons on the side and everything. God, it's disgusting. Sorry, I just actually looked at my mouse right now. God! Oh, I need to wipe you down. Oh, that's so gross. Oh my God. Oh, okay, you know, like, dead skin? That's God, it's just terrible. Is it very different from your home? In Japan, I would say. I mean, I think I would say a pretty huge difference with people and the whole transportation and all that kinds of stuff, culture-wise and everything, is extremely different. I mean, I say culture-wise, but if I'm going to be honest, like, compared to specifically my family, it was just kind of like a, okay, we kind of understand how this goes. Wasn't like a big, huge difference for us. Where we live, it probably would be for a little bit of the norm kind of people. But no, I was honestly pretty good. Also, hello and welcome to see me, Greg. I know, God, I actually looked at it. Like, only time I can really like describe this thing is, you know, if you have like an exercise machine or something and you don't wipe it down often, which I don't. You know how like you can see like all of a sudden like forms this layer and it's like the sweat and like dead skin. How many people am I making like, oh, stop it, stop talking about it. Yeah, I need to wipe that mouse down. I'm not taking care of this thing ever since the scroll wheel has broken. I'm like, it's okay, you will die eventually. Surprisingly, we didn't run into a lot of people like that. We were thinking. I remember the first time we went there, like, there was, I think, one of the areas we were in, there was this other foreigner that was there, and, God, it was, like, just the looks, I could feel everybody just giving that person, I was like, yeah, it's deserved. Yeah, but I believe that's Kyoto, I believe it is. You ever tried doing long form or full length videos? Challenge run gameplay for a game? How I'm gonna edit things together now? I'll answer that question in a second. Also, thank you so much for being a member, Jackson Fox, for 7 months. Thank you, thank you, thank you! Fatum is not a woman, she is a coalition of cockroaches mimicking a woman via vtuber model. Beware! She's after your crumbs and also your toes, probably! So much. I read like a little bit of it and I was like, wait, hold on, I need to read this thing. Thank you so much, Jack the Box, for the 5. Thank you, thank you, thank you. New mouse willing, please, for the love of all that's holy, buy a new mouse. Look, the mouse is fine, okay? The mouse is fine. Honestly, I think it's like one of those things that anything that has to do with like an upgrade for me is kind of like, it can hold, right? It still works. Anything that's like an upgrade for like stream wise for you guys and quality and all that, that's where I'm like, all right, that's the good stuff. Don't worry about it, it's fine. Once this thing dies, then it'll be. Joining the mold tuber meta. Oh. Hello, hello, welcome, Sylvester Inc. But just to answer your question real quick, the only like longer videos I've ever, okay, I take that back. I believe that there's two things that I did. One is obviously my AMVs that were just, 3 minutes long compared to seconds here for shorts and all that. But those were probably, God, just giving you an idea of the reason why I don't make videos is I've already told you guys how long it takes me to do like a short, right? And that's like a couple seconds, right? It could take me about a day, maybe a pretty short amount of time, like within like a couple hours and stuff like that. For me to make an AMV It used to take me about 3 months to make an entire one. Granted, it is a lot of editing, like a ton of editing, right? And for me, what I would do is I would literally go through the entire seasons of whatever anime was. Like, okay, for instance, I'll do Madoka Magica, because that's just one that comes to mind, where you had the anime, and then you had the movies, I mean, that are remakes from the anime, and then you have the sequel movie, right? And all that. I would sit there, going through every part. What's nice is that if it's a show that I know pretty well, then I will remember where certain scenes are and everything. But other than that, I would go through everything to find the clips that I think are good. We're talking, I probably use maybe 10% of the clips that I would find, because I would just find so many things. And then the whole idea of, all right, so this is the song I'm going to use, this is the scenario, so I need to see how everything's gonna fit, what's editing gonna be a little shorter, all that kinds of stuff, going through each of every frame and thinking like, all right, this is gonna fit here, this is like, it's like a puzzle piece, right? It's like a puzzle piece that doesn't have a schematic to it. It's like you have to draw the puzzle, you have to draw the drawing on the puzzle before you could start putting them together. It's exactly how I would describe it. And then, you know, and then after you finally get everything good, like, fit pretty good together, sometimes you have, like, an open gap in between. You're like, oh, shoot, there's, like, a black screen, like, right there. What do? Do I leave it black? Like, is an idea to fade? Or am I gonna add something else there? Maybe I can expand it? All that sorts of stuff. So those used to take me three months for maybe a 3 minute short. I mean, 3 minute AMV, right? Yeah. I did used to a long time ago on my main channel, which is actually, sorry, my personal channel. I there was videos that I did try to do, but those editings were like nothing. Nothing at all. It was just be like, there's quite a bit of silence here. So, yeah, but also again, thank you again, Jackson Fox, for the 5, thank you, asking didn't work, this is now a threat, buy a new mouse or I will donate again, look, it works, all I can say, okay, the buttons on the side, I don't use them, but they work. It's literally only the mouse wheel. And I like the movement of this mouse because it's pretty, like, see, it's very zippy. It's very zippy compared to the other ones, all right? But, like, because, like, I have another mouse. I do. I have another one, but it's one of those, like, it's the battery operated with, like, you connect the little wire. I usually use it for editing because it's a lot slower. So, like, those, I, like, it's slow, right? But when I'm playing a game, like, I want to be, like, pretty quick. I don't know why it's super fast, but it really is. So, you know, it's fine. Don't worry about it. It's okay. Also, what's these things that you can do on them? I see that. What is that? A heart? Cool. Interesting, like, an interactive one. I feel like I said that last time, but I just don't remember. Interesting. But yeah, so I'm not taking care of things. Marla is in the chat now. Hey, she's up there. She's up there walking on you guys. She's actually walking right on the border. That's a little creepy, Marla. How do you have those skills? Don't ask why there's two of them. I'm just very lonely, so it's like a plushie of her on my shoulder right now. That's actually her moving around. You know, she's free for the moment. Yo, just so filled with tourists these days. It's making new headlines how busy it is. Sheesh. We were actually, it's kind of funny because we never made it to Kyoto. We were there for a week and we still didn't do. We did a lot, but we were thinking like, we should try to get to Kyoto. We never made it. We went to, I'm gonna missay it because I can't really recall how it's spelled or how it's said. Odabai? Something like that. It's like an island. It's split. It's I think it's still considered Tokyo, I believe, but it was right there. We were in Tokyo, if you didn't know. We were in Tokyo, but we went there. We made that trip instead of going to Kyoto. It was pretty fun, though. It was pretty fun. It's actually, I believe, the same place that the Persona 3 actually takes place in. So that was it was pretty fun getting there and all that. That was good stuff. EMVs can have a lot of cuts. Oh my god. Like, I pull up, like, my own computer, like, barely functions. It's so slow. But that's the computer that I would make all the AMVs in and everything. And, oh god. Like, I would, like, even look, I can imagine, I can already see it. Like, sometimes some of the shorts I make have quite a few edits in them. But god, when I would look at those AMVs, I'm like, ooh, that's a lot. Sheesh. Being able to see chat like this. She can't avoid seeing it. Okay, I was wondering who's spamming the hearts. I see who it is. Just change DPI. Yeah, see, that's the thing. Like, this one, so it has, like, the button where... Okay, maybe it doesn't... Oh, yeah, see, it's a little slower. And then, yoink! It goes really fast. That's what I like about this one. It's like I said, it's like, it was a very cheap gaming one. Very cheap. It looks nice without the skin. It has like a bronze color to it. So. Look, it's a mouse. It still works. See, look, it's wings. Thank you again, Jackson Fox, for the 5. You were warned. I know. But it's like, oh, you know what? It's been a long time since I've taken a picture and have ever posted it. Alright? I'm gonna take a picture of my mouse and you get to see just how beautiful it is. Alright, you guys, I'm putting it over on the Discord so you can see. Where the heck do I put this? It's been a while since I looked at this. You know what? I'm just gonna put it on the community post because I can't. I'm gonna do that instead. Let's do that, shall we? There we go. Let's see. It's still loading the photo. Hold on. It's taking a while. It's like, oh, this thing is too disgusting. Look, it's fine. It's fine. There he goes. All right. Perfect. Post it. Yes. Too many people who are not watching the stream are going to be like, what the heck is happening? See, it's over the community tab if you want to go see it. It should be public. I hope I made that public. Did I? Yes, see? Beautiful. You can see the skin. Oh, you can see it on there. I need to wipe it. I need to. I don't have a wipe in my room right now. It's beautiful, okay? It's beautiful. Reminds me a little tiny. Kindy? I don't know what happened. Needy over the kindies. God, my brain. Also, music I can hear from my headphones. Turn it off, please. Don't need to hear you. There we go. But yeah. It's beautiful. It's beautiful. It's over the community tab on the channel, okay? It's beautiful. Oh, the old skin particles. Oh. Is there a Martlet plushie? I wish there was. I want one. I would take a Martlet plushie in a heartbeat. I love Martlet. She's the best. Has there been another character on the channel that has impacted the channel this much before? I mean, literally have one on my shoulder. There's one in the background of the schedule. And then there's one moving. Martlet has taken over. Perfectly. I'll just rename my channel to Martlet's channel, shouldn't I? At this point. But, yeah, no. AMVs To edit clips of yourself with your interviews around somewhere more personal to make yourself a focus. I mean, see, my problem is that, like, I have my main problem with, like, different videos and things like that is I don't have it in me to make, like, to give an example, I have a hard time making, like, a video, like, cut, like, for instance, for my streams, right, they're, like, around 3 hours long, and trying to, like, piece them together, like, okay, like, this is what happened in here, make it, like, a sufficient story, what happened within it is a pretty good chunk, while also making little edits on it, and then making it into its own video. For me, I would be watching the whole stream and be like, that entire thing, that is the video, and that will be edited. That is my problem. Is I have a problem where, like, I need to make videos that have, like, enough story that if it's a story game that we're playing, that's enough story within it to feel like a proper, like, okay, this is the part one and this is the part two and part three, like, that kind of thing. It's like that I need done, like, that's my problem, and that's where I look at my stream and I'm like, the whole thing is part one. I think that's where. And then I also have the issue of, like, it has to be, like, on point. Like, there's different things that, like, that needs to be perfect. And also making, like, pretty good, like, fades into next things. Like, if I'm clipping things out that don't need to be in there, that can be just taken away. And, like, I don't know, either I'm getting stuck on something or just, like, a bit of quiet since I'm traveling to back to where I'm supposed to be or something. Like, that kind of stuff. I have, like, I'm not too terrible at trying to fade it into that and make it not feel so choppy, but at the same time, I have a problem with trying to keep things condensed, because I'm like, condensed means 3 hours. I don't know. I have that. That's kind of why I don't make videos. And also, the whole thing with the editing and all that, I can't do the whole editing. The idea of dedicating that time to it, I would very, very hard to be super consistent to where it's not, like, separated by months to get stuff out. That would be one of my issues. But having them come out at, like, a good period. Like, honestly, even with shorts, like, I'm behind right now. I am very, very behind. I literally have the short that I have for tomorrow. And that's it. I don't have the rest for next week. I was working on literally the one for next week right now. I am very behind on them. So it's like, those are seconds. Those are not even, like, you know, five. Those are not edits of three hour streams into making them 20 minutes or something. Which, God, you know how much content I would have for the channel? You realize that, right? How much content I would have? How much? I would just edit it. God. I can't think it's Jackson Fox. It's a beautiful post, okay? It's beautiful. Thank you again for the five. The mouse made me barf a little. I beg you, buy a mouse that doesn't have an inch of dead skin and fungal growth and a working scrub wheel. It's a beautiful mouse. Oh, God. I saw people comment on it. Never looked this bad. I honestly didn't realize it actually was this bad, okay? It is pretty bad. What didn't happen? I was like trying to scrape some of it off. That is really bad. I will say nothing else looks like that. Microphone, beautiful. Camera, I don't touch it. It's fine. Keyboard, a little dusty, but that's about it. Just a little dust. No. It's a mouse, though. That's an abomination. My controllers are nice, though. Yeah, my controllers are nice. Considering that I use these a lot more than I actually use the mouse. Actually, I'm curious about this statistic, right? Do I use my mouse more than I use my controller? Even though I play a lot of games using the controller, but then I also do edit a lot. I don't know what I do use more. My controllers are better, though. What's life like being blind? You don't see those details, apparently. And she's turning her head. Where did Martha go, actually? Oh, she's behind me. Why are you behind me? Go over there. Go tackle chat. I do love that I can just... I can actually... Okay. You know, a little, awareness for the desktop tale, I guess is what I'll say. It's actually pretty cool. So if I right click on her, I can change her character. So she has there's different Undertale ones. So if there's Frisk, good old Frisk, then I can change it to there's Flowey, Toriel, Papyrus, Undyne Armored. Cool, I didn't know about that one. So they have a pretty good amount of these. And then for Undertale Yellow, they have all of Clover, Dal, Martlet, Ed, all of them here too. A pretty good amount too. And then they also seem to have Deltarune, Chris, Dark World, Susie, Rosie, Noelle. Where's Queen? There's a problem here. There's no Queen. And then you can also change the scale so I can make her super tiny. Or can make her, what's four times? Oh my god! Oh my god! Interesting. She's giant. Three times, there you go. And then unfocused movements. I assume that would be me just moving her around. How would Flowey work? Let's see. There's Flowey. Let's see how that one works. Here, I'll put him right there. He's not moving! Oh yeah, and that's the other thing too, is that apparently this also has a function to where you can make your own sprites and put them in there, so you can have your own edited ones and being able to move them around. And then you can have multiple ones too, I believe. I don't know exactly. I'm sure probably if you go into the files and stuff like that, they probably have more things. He's not doing anything. He's just standing there. Can I move him? No, I actually don't even know how to move him. I'm sure probably I changed the function on it. But yeah. Not moving. I mean, I'm gonna change this back to Martlet. But yeah, it's pretty cool. Link in the description if you want to have your own Martlet terrorizing you. And I believe you can also do the function of have multiple characters roaming around, but you know, Martlet best. Oh my god, that's true. I could have Roach crawling around on here. That's actually a really good idea. That would be amazing. Roach with Martlet. That would be perfect. But yeah, it's pretty cool. I'm trying to figure out how I can capture it on OBS, because how you guys are seeing it, basically, I'm just capturing my desktop. So, that's how you're able to see the background. I mean, I was going to say I could make my background into my schedule and everything, but I also can't because I have the rotating on the... I mean, I guess in a way I can do what this is doing, right? Huh. Maybe I might try that. Maybe we might see. I mean, it's only once a month though that we actually see Martlet and everything walking around. But yeah, it's pretty cool. It went in your mouth when you were talking with your head turned. Oh god, she goes. Oh, she does go through my face. Oh, I'm so sorry, Martlet. I slice you with my hair and you go inside of my face. Oh, sheesh. Oh my god. That makes Fatum go on your screen and see the shortcut icons like a goblin. That's a good one. Custom Roach. Yeah, the custom Roach would be good. With that mouse abomination. Look, mouse is fine, okay? Mouse is fine. God, I don't even think I captured the right side of it. Oh god, I don't have a wipe. I don't have one in my room. If I did, I'd wipe it, but at the same time, I'd be afraid of clicking something and shutting things off accidentally. Oh my god. We talked about roaches constantly flying into my chest. Oh god, that game.
That game was amazing. That game. If you don't know what game I'm talking about, then there's a gem on my channel called the milk inside a bag of milk inside a bag of milk inside a bag of milk and milk outside a bag of milk outside a bag of milk inside a bag of milk. That is amazing. Amazing. Definitely 100%. Drink some milk if you watch it. Go watch it and go enjoy a glass of milk with it. Right, Marlet? Right? Have some good milk. Oh my god. But how has March been? I don't know if anybody had answered, but how has March been? March been, you know, tired. Been your hardest month so far of the year. Torture. Sorry, March has not been good to me. I don't know if that's noticeable. How's March been? How's March been? Especially now that we're, I mean, sheesh, technically for most of you it's already the last day or you're coming up on the end of it already. Or it will be your end very, very soon of March. How it's been? Destroying me now. What did I miss? school. Pain and suffering. Hello, God to Jake. Welcome. Did I say hello? Welcome, Red Man. Alien Rodriguez. I don't remember. Hello and welcome. Remind me of the end is never the end, 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 is never the end. God! Like those repeating ones, you can just really just continue on forever. It's been rough. God. It has been. I don't know what's been with March. March has just been slapping everybody in the face. It's like I said it too in the beginning of the year that things were starting slow and then things were just gonna start slapping everybody. don't even apologize to me. Working two jobs and going to college. Oh my god. Sheesh. Yeah, I can see why you're tired, yeah. Oh god. Jeez. Enjoyed playing. And somebody, I don't know what he's talking about. It's fine. I mean, that's good. At least one of us is not dying. It was fun. It was fun. I always like playing the games with you guys. Those are always very, very fun. Very good. Very hectic. Those are some good old times. Lost a lot of motivation being bad. Yep. March do that. I don't know why. I always feel like it's every March, right? Every time March comes around, it's like doomsday. It's like March approaches and everyone's like, no, not March. Maybe it's just me, but I March has never ever been a good month for me. It's always just been terrible. Is that about your birthday? Well, happy birthday. You know what? Get to celebrate it again right here, alright? They said that too before. You get another one, okay? Happy birthday. And ask me more if you think I recovered some sleep hours, though. Oof. Oh, welcome, Extreme. Well, I think that's been one of the hardest things right now, too. It's just, like, trying to catch up on sleep. Sleep is just, like, there, been mocking me. It's literally just been, like, come to me, but you don't want to. You got other things to do than sleep, don't you? But you need it, don't you? That's exactly how that's been feeling. Coffee has been my lifesaver, even though it doesn't do much anymore. One of my favorite funny gaming experiences today. Truly March Madness in the worst ways. I've always heard of March Madness. What is exactly March Madness? I've heard that's what it's been called. Like, what is it supposed to be referencing? I don't understand. 3 hours last night. Plenty of rest. You got 3 hours to sleep. Woo! Sheesh. Oh, God. Yeah, no. No, it's just like one of those things, right? It's
when you finally get done with everything you need to do in the day, and it's finally like time is closing and everything's good, like it's nice and quiet and it's peaceful, and it's like one of those, especially for me, it's one of those moments of like, it's time to sleep, but also I finally have time for myself and I could catch up on things I need to catch up on, or just like enjoy the night and have some good times, just relaxing. Or I can go to sleep and wake up the next day and have to do it all over again. That's what it usually is for me when it comes to night times, where I'm like, I don't want to sleep. I don't want to. I think it's a football thing. Huh. I don't know. I'm not a very sports person. I don't know if you guys could ever guess that. I'm not a sports person at all, so. Interesting. Is the NCAA tournament just 14th bracket college basketball tournament? You find the national. Oh, it's okay. It's a basketball thing. Still don't know it. Bigger and better than being professional basketball. I like Red Man. It was kind of there. You were in the sports. I thought it was some, I don't know, social thing or something. Like, I don't know. I thought it was some convention event or something. Which is, talking about like conventions and all that. Like, I know there's been a lot, especially within March. There's been a ton all over the world for different things. Recently, the one where I live and everything, one's coming up soon. I say anime convention because it's what most of the people go there for, but it's like all different, like different comics and all that kinds of stuff, video games and all that fun stuff. It's coming up in one of these weekends, and I it's kind of funny because we've been having them for a very long time, but I just never went to one. I was just so tired and so busy, and I was like, nah, I'm good, but. Not last year, but I believe the year before, I actually had finally went to one, and because my cousin was like, hey, like, I'm gonna dress up, are you gonna come with me and everything, and I was like, I don't, but also, it'd be nice to spend time with you, so, it was actually pretty fun, it was pretty cool, everybody got to see some pretty cool costumes and all that, and, just everything that they had in the area, so, since we didn't go last year, and then with this year, it was coming up in April, and my cousin again was like, hey, like, this is what I'm gonna dress up. She does very, very cool. She makes her own costumes and everything, which is just amazing. She's very, very good at that kinds of stuff. And so it's always just awesome to see what she makes and everything. So she was just telling me that she was going again, and I was like, I guess maybe. So that's something I'm actually looking forward to. It's not this coming weekend, I think it's the following weekend or something like that. But like the whole like idea with the conventions and all that, I see here like everybody talk about them. Like, oh yeah, they have all this stuff and everything. It's like the one where I live is just like, yeah, woo, we have something. We don't do a lot of things. I feel like where I live just lives under the rock with me. We all live under the rock. But yeah. But that's kind of what I thought, like, the whole thing with March was like, oh, it's like conventions, social things or something. I thought that's what March Madness was. I didn't realize it was a sports thing, which I see. I just remembered to ask, did you make your bed today? Sure. Sure. Yeah. Definitely. 100%. Yep, that's made. that's definitely made. That's made. It's very made bed. Yep. Yep. Hey, look, I'll give this an upgrade. I'm actually wearing like normal, regular going outside clothes. I had to do something right before stream and I didn't get a chance to change back. So I'm not in sleepwear, okay? I'm not in sleepwear. That's the best thing about doing this whole like VTuber thing. It's like I don't have to get ready. It's the nice thing. I don't have to brush my hair. I can be a complete mess. I don't have to change my clothes, make sure I don't have holes in my shirt or anything. It's just like, click, good. That's the nice thing about doing it like this. That's the nice thing. It's kind of funny, right? Like, there's ups and downs to doing the VTubing compared to just doing, like, just a normal camera and all that. Obviously, identity being one of them. And then second is, for me, it'd be happy to get ready and be like, go find some pants. make sure my shirt don't have holes. All that kind of stuff. And then would I make my bed? No, I wouldn't. I still wouldn't make my bed. My bed is like directly behind me, so you see me actually turning. I am turning to look behind me. I know that still wouldn't be made. That would be a complete mess. I don't like making beds, okay? I don't like them. Right, but then like there's also like the stuff that like the downside to me is that like I can't have fun where I can't like wave at you guys and you guys see me waving at you and like just spinning around the chair and you guys actively seeing that or like the effect of like me walking away and actually like going to slam the door or something like that, right? Like you guys don't get to have like that kind of fun stuff and then you know just other fun projects and things like that that I would have, but I don't know. It's like a good ups and downs. Oh, my son just bought them. It's been a rough couple months. I bought them back from my generations. Should be sleepy. Oh, God. Yeah. Oh, well, I appreciate it, but maybe I help you sleep, right? Maybe just have the volume very low, so when I scream, especially like I think the ones where it's a lot more reading and stuff like that, or even just I guess the chatting ones too, or things like hopefully I help you sleep in that sense. Just have it down to something you just listen to and drown out. That's what I usually do. That's when I get really good sleep. I get really good sleep, and even though it's like a few hours because I don't turn off my lights or anything because I'm not ready to go to bed, I just have like my computer on or something and I'm watching a video and I'm just like tucked in bed and just laying down and watching it and then just kind of like just zone it out and end up like falling asleep for a little bit. When I wake up from those, God, I wake up so good from those. I don't know why. I'm usually the type of person that doesn't like to sleep with any lights, any noise. I don't like having like the TV on or like computer, anything on. I don't like that kind of stuff. I've always hated it. But for some reason, I think like those are probably the times where I'm just so exhausted that I don't mean to fall asleep. Those are always good. Those are always good. Those are always good. But yeah. The big deal is I really look at the expression of the entire game. Like definitely bet on them, I guess. Right? The gambling ones. Millions of dollars. God. Sheesh. I'll say goodbye for Jackie Fox. Thank you so much for coming. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Hopefully things get a little bit better for you with your hectic schedule. Thank you for coming. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I'm afraid that your parents sometimes want to move your streams. Are you afraid that you might say something that you don't want your family to hear you say sometimes? No, I wouldn't say so. I honestly, if I'm gonna be honest, the stuff that I say on stream, I say, how do I say this? I guess I'm not ashamed of anything that I say on stream. I'm not. I don't have anything to hide. I don't have anything that I'm like, oh no, don't want you to hear that or anything like that. No. Honestly, I and then I also don't, if you probably noticed, I don't keep it in mind that my family probably is watching some of the content and stuff like that, but no, I don't have anything to hide. I don't, just, you know, having fun, chilling, talking. So yeah, I don't know. I've never really streamed something or done something and talk about stuff thinking like, oh shoot, my family might be watching or something like that. Because I don't really think I've said anything that's like, ooh. You know, the cheese. But yeah, I'm wearing upside clothes today. I am. I actually have like pants on and a t-shirt on. And that's about it. I took my shoes off. I just have socks on, which is weird. I don't ever really wear socks. I don't like them. I don't like them. But, you know, just have that on. Comfy. Although the pants are gonna make me heat up in a second. I know that. I know. I hear my computer like running, and it's like, you're gonna cook me right now. I know you are. You're trying to. I can't sleep with any lights or noises unless I'm super exhausted. Yeah. Yeah, that's usually like how I know that I'm like, oof, I'm tired. If I end up falling asleep from just watching something, because I mean, literally, like, if I'm just so exhausted, I can't do anything for the rest of the day. Like, most of the time, I will try to take just any time that I have free time, I'll try to make as many shorts as possible and work on, like, projects for the stream and stuff like that. Like, I'll do my best to do that kind of things. But sometimes, like, I'm just so tired. And I don't like working on stuff for stream when I'm tired. It's just, like, I feel like I'm not putting in my all because I'm tired. And I don't like that. That makes me annoyed. I don't like it. It's also one of the things I hate, being tired. So I'll just choose to, like, okay, I'll lay in bed for a minute and then I'll get up and then I'll be a little bit better and work on stuff. So go ahead and lay down and go do it and then shoot. So, yeah. Something's going on over me. I miss my parents so much. Aww. Of course, I'll give a dog. I don't have a dog with me right now, but I'll give all my puppers a hug for you. Aww. That's sweet. Well, good night, Tentapai. Good night. Sleep well. Hope you enjoy time with your parents or family. Don't know exactly your parents, but your family that are coming to see you. Hope you have a good time. Thank you for coming. But yeah. Well, I would recommend watching you for a number of reasons. Sleepless, that's like not one of them. What is this? Just the random, you know, just the random. Is that what the reason might be? I do tend to scream randomly at even games that shouldn't make me scream but still make me scream. God. Maybe it's a before going to bed, right? Just before going to bed entertainment. No pants. Are you sleep clothes? Just no clothes? Oh, no. I never liked the idea of sleeping with nothing. I don't at all. No. Sleepwear is t-shirt and shorts. And that's usually what my sleepwear is. It's literally like just random workout shorts that are just way too big for me to just wear out and about. So I'm like, you know what? You are now sleep shorts. Usually how all my clothes turn into. If they're too big for me, I'll be like, all right, you're gonna be a... Which is weird, but think about it, because usually your clothes are supposed to get smaller as when they're older clothes because you grew and everything, so it's like, ah! Am I shrinking? but yeah, no, like, clothes that usually, like, just fit too big, or if they got, like, stains on them or something, I'll be like, eh, you're sleepwear now. So, yeah. I have, like, a couple of, like, workout shorts that I used to wear that are just too big, or I'm like, okay, you are now sleeping shorts, so those are comfy. I know. I've never liked sleeping. Like, I know they have, like, the... I had to sneeze. Is it coming or is it leaving? Okay. Like, I feel it. It's still there. Go away. Go away. Go away. Oh. But I wish they were dogs. True, I understand, I understand, I understand. Just imagine them as dogs, okay? Just imagine. Just don't start petting them. Gets weird. Speaking from experience. But, yeah. No, I just, like... That's the truth. I never like just wearing either, like, I know they have, like, the sleep gowns or, like, just a one kind of, like, dress idea, and then obviously your normal pajamas that are, like, matching and all that. It's like, no. Like, obviously clothing that's, like a close fit and everything, that for sleepwear, no. God, no. Uh-uh. Nice loose shirt and loose pants or shorts, I should specify. Very good, very good. Not too long ago. Ah, I see. No, honestly, no. I maybe I just have such small memories sometimes about things that happen within stream that I'm not aware of anything that's like, But no, most of the time I'm just like, eh. I'm usually pretty good about it. How much chocolate in a month? God, chocolate is like the only treat worth eating, if I'm gonna be honest. Like, any other treat, kind of like, but chocolate. Chocolate or, like, specialty drinks is usually, like, the things that get me. I like that kinds of stuff. But, like, snacking on different things, I don't... I mean, for instance, like, streaming takes a lot of my day. Which I'm not saying it's a bad thing, but just giving you guys an idea. Hi, Marlin. Do you see her now? I didn't like that you were just went down there and staring at me. It's a little creepy. Don't do that. They're creepy. But I don't really have, like, especially with streaming, like, and most of my drinks that I drink or anything that I have is usually stuff that I can drink, especially, like, with milk if I'm hungry or like a shake or something, because it's just harder to eat, like, physical objects but not liquid objects where I can just take a sip of it and then continue talking, where I have to munch on it. So usually I just don't end up eating too much throughout the day. And usually, like, I have just, like, one meal and I'm like, all right. And it's like, usually I eat, like, when I'm closer to bedtime and everything. It's like, well, yes, this is the meal I'm having for the day. Cool. So yeah, I don't know. I don't eat often. The days, though, that I'm usually, like, have, especially the days that I don't stream and everything, those delicious. Eat so much. And that's the thing, like, especially for me, like, I can eat so much food. I'm one of those people that I am just hungry, because I think especially attributes to the idea that I don't eat for a lot of the days often. I just usually eat, like, a single meal or something. So when I have the chance to eat, it's like, like, I will eat everything. And those are the times it's, like, delicious. And then what doesn't help is the whole exercising too and everything. Getting back into that and all that, it makes my appetite just skyrocket, where it's like, I need to eat something. I'll start looking at my pugs. You look pretty juicy. No, my pugs would eat me before I could eat them, I'm gonna be honest. I swear, Shima stares at me sometimes and gives me that look like, I'm gonna eat you. God, I haven't talked about Shima, what she did recently. So, if you don't know, Shima's my oldest pug. She is adorable, sweet, and I love her. But she doesn't love me as much because she loves food. Her loyalty is within food and only food. To give you an idea, it has to be human food. Not so much dog food, but human food. It has to be human food. So, usually, like, in the kitchen, cooking or anything, like anything that spills, she literally sits there and waits for anything that will fall. Anything that will fall, she'll eat it in like a heartbeat. Even if you're cooking something on a pan and it falls out, God, it doesn't matter how scorching hot that thing is, she will get it down. It's terrifying. A while back, we were making some pies and, you know, we had the oven on. It's like your normal kind of stove. And then the oven, you pull it down and everything, right? It was hot. Really, really hot. There's Shima. She's sitting right next to it. Just sitting there, like she usually does. She always sits really close to it, I think because of the warmth and everything. She likes it. She literally... She sits funny. Have you never seen how to pug fit? Like, they sit like right on their butt. And they have, like, their stomach, like, just out. It's weird. It's a weird pose. They don't sit like a normal dog. They sit with their gut out, basically. I don't know why, but they do. I don't know if because they have the long limbs kind of idea and, like, a shorter body. I don't know, but they sit really weird. She looked over at the stove. Like, we had it down, and we were pulling the stuff out. She looked over at the stove, the metal part. In the opening, in the inside of it, licked it. Licked the stove. I mean, sorry, the oven while it was on. It's been on. We were pulling the pies out. She licked the oven. Did not cry. Did not whimper. Didn't do anything. Literally just moved her head back up and just sat back in her position. Tell me that dog is not an alien. I couldn't believe it. I was waiting for her tongue to start melting. I was waiting to getting to pick her up and having to rush her to a vet. For her to start crying, to grab ice, anything. I was literally waiting for anything. Nothing. She acted like it was nothing. That thing was hot. It was very hot because I accidentally bumped my hand against it when I was trying to pull some of the pies out. Pugs are aliens. I swear, she will eat me one day. She will. If I sleep too long, that's why I can't sleep, because she will eat me one of these days. That's why. Being eaten by a pet sounds like a skill issue to me. God, I couldn't. Freak. We make popcorn on the, like, we have like a bowl that you put like the oil and all that, like, we make the popcorn, right? We don't have like a popcorn machine, we just make the popcorn ourselves. We have that. Anytime like the popcorn pops out and everything, she is there ready to catch it. And it's like that thing is coming out of the stove from boiling oil and you're just like numb, like nothing. We've checked her mouth, we checked everything to make sure she's fine, taking her to the vet just to get her checkups and stuff like that. Nothing. They find nothing. I'm like, how? There has to be something wrong. That dog is an alien. If you don't own a pug, you don't know anything about pugs. All I can tell you is that they are aliens. They are not from this world. And they will defeat all of us and take over the world. I 100% believe it. You own a pug, you understand what I am talking about. If you don't, I sound like a madman. But it will happen. My alien, thank you so much for coming. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Take care. But, yeah. No, I, yeah. Any doubt I had about pugs being aliens went out the door the minute that happened. I'll give you another example. My dad was looking at the pugs. Because we have... So, my pug is Shima and Bonbon. They're my adorable, beautiful pugs. my dad has a pug, Cubae, and she's adorable too. She was supposed to be mine. My dad ended up raising her, and she loves him. So I was like, all right, fine. and so she doesn't act like a pug though. Cubae doesn't. She's not like a pug compared to Bon Bon and Chima. That dog is not a pug. But he had a pickle, and just out of curiosity's sake, because it's literally, it's gotten to that point of what will Shima eat and what will Shima not eat? Literally, that is the question when it comes to people food. What would she eat? You can give her a piece of lettuce and she will devour that thing like it's the best thing on the planet. I don't understand. So, he gave, like, we had the other dogs too, and he tried giving them the pickle. They don't want it. They lick it and bleh. Nope, they walk away from it. They did not want it. Shima would try to gobble it, spit it out, and, like, shake her head intensely, and then, like, look back at it. She'd pick it up again, try chewing it, shake her head, spit it back out, like, make this nasty look on her face, and keep picking it up to try to keep eating it. And she repeated the pattern for a good long time until she ate it. I don't know what to say. I have an alien in my home that if I fear Toka for being a demon, my god, I fear Shima for being an alien. I have an alien, I have a demon. How much more can I ask for in my household? I don't understand. And you want another thing about pugs is they scream. They don't bark, they scream. From excitement, from howling, they scream. It is the weirdest thing. My mom likes to give them ice, and anytime like she's over and the dogs will start, like Shima knows it's her, she'll start screaming like happy. Like meow, that exact sound. Apparently, one of the times that I was streaming and my dad was here, he heard Shima just go like rah, rah, sounds, and my dad was like, oh, we got an alien in the house. Pugs are fascinating creatures. This is what I'm trying to get at. I don't understand them. Nothing. Their owners are often share similar personality traits. So, you know what's funny about that? So, I got Marky, Shima, and Bon Bon, right? Marky, my boy, he's the older boy, and he is lazy. Which, yes, I am lazy. I understand. Like, he is... I hate to say it, but... He looks like... You know, like, the stereo, like, typical thing that they do with, like, what is it called? Like... Not beach people, but like the whole like peace and love and like doo kind of idea. That is literally my Marky boy. He will just like, he looks like he's so out of it. He's so lazy. You can like nudge him and he'll just roll on his back and be like, okay. he'll be so chill about everything, no matter what you do. He's also such a big wimp, so one of the times we dropped, like, a paper napkin next to him, and he, like, screamed bloody murder, and I'm like, it just fell, boy. He is another thing. He likes to sit up on his hind legs and just kind of, like, stare at you. That's another thing. He has, like, these big puppy eyes, and he'll just stare at you forever without doing anything. And just stare. And stare. Like, that's all he will do. So, yeah, I can see the personality thing. The whole thing about liking food. I like food. I do. I do like food. So, Shima, yeah, I 100% agree. I'm willing to try things that most people would look at me and be like, excuse me? Bon Bon. She's a puppy right now, okay? She's a puppy, and she likes to eat everything. God, she
she eats everything. Every time I see her, she's chewing something she's not supposed to be and trying to eat it, and I'm like, stop eating. She'll bring stuff from outside and she'll bring it in, like she has like these wood chunks, and I'm like, there's splinters now all over the floor. Why do you have to eat everything? So yeah. And she's also very hyper. She loves giving licks and kisses and everything, and God, she goes nuts. She's a puppy. She's a puppy and she's hyper. So yeah, they're similar, all right. We're similar. He moved through it, outweighing the fleeting pains. Yeah, no, she didn't even care. I think that's the thing, though, is that she went to the point that, like, she didn't get anything from the other. She didn't. She just looked at it, licked it, and then just looked back, like, eh. Like, nothing afterwards. So what the heck? God. I don't know. That dog is something else. I've heard that too. I've heard that a lot too, that dogs are supposed to resemble your own personality. And I look at my dog and I'm like, yep. I look at Toka and I'm like, maybe. I fear you more than I think you are like me. Plants, humans are psychopath. Plants making themselves spicy to make themselves less appetizing, and humans find spicy plants are like, ooh, tasty. You're not wrong. You're actually right. Although, you know, that would repel me. I will be honest. That will repel me because I do not like spicy things. I hate spicy. Who likes spicy in chat? Who likes spicy food? Like, we're talking spicy but spicy. Not a little bit of spice. We're talking that thing has the 3 chili marks on it. You know what I'm talking about. You know exactly what I'm talking about. It was kind of funny. I went to Japan and I saw the chili marks and I'm like, oh, hey. I know about those. Those are death. And will I say, where I live, they love spicy. They love spicy food. I don't know why. I don't know why. But they're in Japan. That level of spiciness, one little, like, it's one chili mark. It was death. I was dying. My uncle, who loves spicy food, was dying. It was delicious, don't get me wrong, but it was also death. I don't know what everybody was like. Everyone's like different categories of spiciness. It's like, I don't really know if there's anyone who dislikes food. I mean, I was about to say, I'm like, I mean, I can see, like, especially with people who do have the whole thing about being anorexic and stuff like that, but I don't think it's so much as a concept as they don't, like, dislike the taste of food. Like, all different types of food, they don't dislike the taste of it, but more just, like, the idea of consuming calories and things like that. I guess it's more of the thought process for that disliking food, probably. These people made us excited about pugs. I mean, I can believe it. I can 100% believe it. The other thing too, you know, when you're like working on something on the floor, either you're cleaning something or, you know, sitting down, putting together something. You lay on your side or anything like that, or like you're sitting crisscross and you're like leaning over a little bit. Shima is, she's small, but she's a pretty chunky pug, okay? She's up there. She's pretty chunky. I'm not surprised with how much she loves food. But that dog has amazing balance. No matter how you're laying on the ground, and no matter how far away she is, she will all of a sudden appear sitting on you. And if you, like, try to, like, you know, like, wiggle to try to get her off, she will use her hands. I say hands because those things are not paws. And, like, claws into you to, like, make you either stop or keep her balance in. I don't know how she does it. She will balance herself anywhere just to make herself be on you. And that's the other thing with pugs. Pugs have to be on you. No matter what, they have to be somewhere on you. Even if it's like a hand on you,
They have to be touching you some way, somehow. I don't understand. I know. It is bizarre. You, like, especially when you're leaning on your side. My father and I, we were working on a long time ago for my desk and everything. We were putting it together. And my dad was on his side. And Shima just came out of nowhere and, like, jumped. Got on top of him and just menched. Like, it was like a leech. It's like a leech. There you go. It's like a... You know how leeches are thick? That is what Shima is. Shima is a giant leech. That is exactly what she is. I love her, though. I love her so much. But also, God, she is a leech. She is quite literally a leech. It's... Yeah, no. 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 I like spicy. I hate sweet. Really? See, I like sweet food. I do. I mean, okay. Like, caramelized stuff, probably. Like, I like caramelized onions are pretty delicious. Those are pretty good. Like, some bio buns. Like, sometimes the bread is a little sweet for the filling and everything. Like, that's pretty good. Like a Korean, like, barbecue bio bun. Those are, like, pretty good. Those are pretty sweet and stuff like that. Like, that kind of sweet stuff I like. But, like, spicy, really? I can't with spicy. Like, some stuff that is spicy is pretty delicious. Like, don't get me wrong. I love red coconut curry. It is one of my favorite curries. I love it so much. It's spicy, though. But it's good. I'm willing to risk my acid, my stomach acid, to get some coconut red curry. Because, God, it's delicious. But not liking sweet stuff. Huh. I just don't care about spiciness. And why? Like, it's better for being spicy. I guess, like, it adds a flavor to it or something, maybe? I don't know, right? Like, I guess maybe there's also some spices that are spicy, but they have their own unique taste to it. Kind of idea. Like, I read into that a lot in Japan. Like, there was quite a lot of spicy stuff when we were there. Which was like, oh my god, I need to avoid it. But there was like quite a lot of spicy stuff, and a lot of it had like its very own unique flavor compared to like you would. It was interesting, like, we, especially with ramen, we would get the same bowl, but my uncle, like I said, he liked spicy, so he would get the spicy version of it. And like, it had its own unique taste to it, like underneath the layers of spice, so it's kind of where I guess that it is, but also. Death. That is death. the challenge my. You're not wrong. Also, for those maniacs that are just like, I need to test this. You're not wrong. But also, God, to those of you when that comes out. I pray for your soul, that it is a very quick and painless death, because God, I think that's the worst part about when you eat spicy stuff, is when it comes out the other end. Oh, like sometimes, like the surprising ones are when it's like so spicy and you think about it and you're like, shoot, and then you never feel it. It's like, what happened? What happened to it? What, did it just numb everything? What happened? Oh, spicy. It's weird though, right? It's weird that how out of all, like, I mean, sure, you got like asparagus and you got like different things like that, that when coming out, just like, it's still it, going through the whole intestines and your stomach and the stomach acid and all that and the whole processing and everything that your body does to it, that it can still persist in some way, somehow. Spiciness. It terrifies me that thing can persist. God. It's true, jalapenos and habaneros have flavors that are distinct from each other. Yeah. No, I don't. No, anytime I see like jalapenos somewhere, I'm like, nope. Nope. I. No, nope. Just gonna fling that out of there. No, thank you. Like spicy in small doses. So with contrasting dips? What do you mean by that? Contrasting dips. What does that mean? Did habanero... I'm sorry, what? Hold on. Habanero cooks. Nope. Habanero cookies. They're flavorful. I mean, I can imagine. But also, what? I have never heard of that before. Like, as like a sweet cookie or like a bitter cookie? Like, Pepper's too angry to die. That idea that, like, they say, like, ooh, that Pepper angry. It's like the idea of, like, spicy food. Like, it's an angry food. Whoever made that was like, whew, had a lot of steam to blow. There is a happy little opportunity. Elder Beast is only at level one. God, you're not wrong. You're not wrong. But why? Why would you want to do that? Why would you play Elden Ring with fist only? Why? Why would you do that? God. Isn't that like the worst weapon too? Was the brawler stuff and everything? It's basically a circle. You're not wrong. You're not wrong. It's those people that for some reason live for the challenge. Which I've never understood. I don't know. I've just never been. I say that. In the past, I was a competitive person, sort of, kind of, not really, but like, I don't know. Just like the idea of competing is just like, I'm so tired. I don't wanna compete some more. I'm just too tired to do it. Ghost peppers are actually enjoyable. Do you play Elden Ring with fist only, Sylvester Inc? excuse me. You chop the habanero spines, soak them in milk to draw out the worst of the heat. I guess that's. I didn't. Sorry, I just was thinking, how would that milk taste? Oh no, look, I'm not one of those people. I just like to try different weird stuff that normally you wouldn't ever think. How does that taste? Did you try the milk? Please tell me you did. Please. And essentially add them to sugar cookies. So, like, it's one of those mixtures where it sounds like death, but at the same time sounds like it might be good, but also sounds like it might be pretty disgusting. Okay, good. I was wondering about that. Thank you. Thank you for being the test subject there. Thank you. God. Ranch or sweet dips? Oh, with spiciness like that. I don't like ranch. Oh, I don't. Like, usually, I guess with dips, like, God, I'm trying to, like, even think, like, if I even really eat dips. Like, the only dips, like, I've ever really seen are, like, the one, like, with, like, different, chips and stuff like that. Like, especially the tortilla ones, those. Like, that's usually, like, the common one that I usually see. If there's any, like, dip, because other than that, it's just nothing. It's just, like, different appetizers you can get, but... Like, I don't know. I never really have been a chip person. I say that, but I do like them, but I just don't eat them. I don't really keep them around and everything, because it's like, why? I don't need to eat. I get like that. That is the problem I do have with that, is that usually I get to, like, certain points where I'm like, I don't need to eat. So why? I don't mean to. Not yet, anyways. Later I can eat. It's not good. But I do tend to do that a lot. And then it's like the end of the day, and then it's like, oh, food. Necessary, right. I had hatch chili pepper combined. Oh, I read that it's combined. I'm like, combined with what? What the heck did you combine that with? With cornbread. Okay. That was good. Yeah, I guess I can see that. I've seen jalapeno cornbread, and my grandmother loves that. Yeah, I guess I can see that. I guess I can. But I wouldn't eat it. That stomach acid is too far too great, and it will defy everything. And it's not like as a kid that I ate a lot of spicy stuff. God, even as a kid, I avoided spicy stuff so much. Like, my grandmother would look at me and she'd be like, really? I'm like, I know. But, yeah, no, I never really did like spicy stuff. Jolo chips, very sweet. Jolo chips. A few hours to kill. More kid fight with Barry with Fist. For the first boss in the game. Look, okay. Okay, look. I don't remember how long it took me to beat Margot, but I do believe it was around the 2 hour mark. I remember it was hilarious, but the final boss for Elden Ring, the second time that I fought it to get the other ending for stream, took me 2 hours, even though I have already fought that boss before. I don't know why it took me forever to do it again, but... Look, okay. God, I'm so excited for the DLC. That's gonna be so much fun. It's gonna be terrible, but also fun because it's been a while since I played it. But also, I'm very excited for that. That'll be very good times. Now I want to try the spicy milk. Yeah. Like, I'm sure it has a good flavor. Maybe. But also, I've never understood drinks that are spicy. Right? Am I the only one who's like, especially like, out of all things that can be spicy, why would you make drinks spicy? Like, for some reason, I mean, okay, this isn't alcohol, so it's not necessarily like a normal chug drink, but there was an alcohol that I saw that it was a spicy alcohol, and it was like I think it was a vodka or something, and I was like, what? My mother loved it, and I was like, you are insane. It's like, alcohol and spiciness is not a good combo. You don't know alcohol actually enhances the chemicals for the spiciness, basically, to make it go, whew. So, yeah, no. Cornbread is like food of the immortal. You know, I know I don't like bread, but I like cornbread. Cornbread's pretty good. Cornbread is like a pretty good. Like, I don't know. I think it's bread that is not necessarily just bread, right? Like, it has a flavor to it. Like, it's different. It's different than like buying a loaf of bread, baguette, or something, right? It's different. It makes it different to where it's like, okay, it's different enough to where I'm eating you. You're not just like, I'm just eating bread. I don't know. Cornbread is good. Cornbread is delicious. Very good. Do you ever find Melania? Let me see your playthrough. We did fight Melania on stream. Yeah, we did. I had people join in and everything on that one, but Mimic fight with that one? Mm-hmm. But no, I do remember having somebody help out with that fight. It was difficult at first. And I was also doing the stupid thing where I was wearing all the clothing of all my dead friends. You haven't seen my Elden Ring playthrough. That's a roller coaster. It's the how to not play Elden Ring. What I should retitle that series to. Can we drink alcohol while it is lit on fire? God. That's the other thing too, and I see people with the whole fire thing and everything. It's like, no! That alcohol spills and you're dead. I hope you didn't like your nerves very much, because that's just death now. Thank you. God. Is more important than the armor stats? Well, I'll be honest. It wasn't so much for the fashion. It was just like, oh no, my friend is dead. I will now put your clothes on. So, yeah. So I was just looking at the comments for the post that I had made. The mouse is fine, okay? The mouse is beautiful. It's fine. Fire is not death. Have you not seen fire eaters? But that's the thing, right? That's the thing. Those people are trained with fire. Those people are trained with fire. They know what they're doing. Most of the people that are doing these fire shots are not trained and are just stupid. I don't know if you guys had seen that one where, I mean, there's probably a bunch of them where he goes to drink it and the alcohol just spills all over him. He panics, throws like the shot, and it gets on his hair, and he's just like screaming, patting himself down. He has like poofy hair and everything, and he's just rolling and dying. And it's like, oh my god. Oh. What's up with the hermit crab run? Yeah. Yeah. No, Elden Ring was fun. I'm very excited for the DLC. That's gonna be a fun playthrough to go through. Which, I mean, it's soon, right? June? So what, 2 more months or something? Marlet's being creepy again. But yeah, two more months, I believe. Sheesh. Very soon I'll be coming out. I'm trying to think of, like, my favorite playthroughs on stream. Like, for streaming it. Not just for the whole game content and everything, but just the whole experience through streaming it. I think I mentioned before that Outer Wilds was one of my favorites. Just because it was just so fun with everybody interacting and trying to solve a whole puzzle thing. That one was very, very well done. And then probably the other game I would probably have to say would be Elden Ring is coming to mind, because it's literally the one I'm thinking of right now. But probably, honestly, Elden Ring, just because of having different people join in and helping in with the fights and everything, was pretty fun. But I do have to say, I think Outer Wilds would probably just it's just very, very good, a fun experience on stream and everything. Like, I would say Undertale Yellow, but like I said, like, for like the interaction with those stream and everything, or on the chat, that was just a fun experience. I like that. That was good. I'm looking forward to this one again too. It's been a lot of fun. Looking forward to the Paper Mario remake, since that's May, not June. Oh, like, there's no other games that I really know of. I mean, for stream-wise, like, I'm still waiting for The Coffin of Andy and Lele. I'm waiting... Apparently... Actually, you know what? No, you guys can see my desktop. Here, hold on. Let me do this real quick, and then I'll pull it up in a second. Let me just scoop the Steam page over to the other side, so I can go and check something out real fast. Okay. So, where did Twitch go? Why did Twitch disappear? What happened? There you go. Okay. And then here. Okay. So let me pull up. I'm curious. Because apparently there was an update for to slay the princes, I believe. I don't know if it is yet or if it's coming. No, it is out. Oh, fascinating. Here, let's scoot it over so you guys can see it. You guys should be able to see it, although I think I'm in the way of it, but yeah. Marlet's in the way too. But yeah. Should I wait for the first Steam cut to play the game? Is a major and free story something you have planned for later this year? Oh! A 25% adding several brand new routes and significantly lengthening several others. Or should I wait? Question. Media player revisiting at least once. I think in the bucket there should be nothing stopping you from getting up right now, getting an ideal first experience, and then revisiting new routes when we come out later this year. You sort of person who always plays a game at once, then you should. Cool, so there is interesting. So the end of everything content is updated here. Excited to share a surprise content update with you. This is not the Pristine Cut. I didn't even know that there was a Pristine Cut coming out. Oh, I can kind of see in the background some music things. Oh, that'll be something I have to think about if we're gonna wait for the Pristine Cut or just give this a shot and see what it is. Finally, only improve the game. You know, there's some folks who want to go back to an early build. And access the betas and properties, and official time translation. Interesting. Cool. I didn't know that there was more. I didn't know that there was more content later to be released about that game. So yeah, like, those are the kinds of games that, like, I just kind of keeping my eye on, just waiting for more stuff to be coming out and everything. But that's actually pretty cool. I didn't know that game was actually gonna have a lot of content. That's the game that I'm forgetting. Slay the Princess was also just very fun to play with chat and everything. That was a lot of fun. Having to try to see if we can find all the different routes and all the different things, and picking the different dialogue options and the cheese. Can't miss the cheese in there. That was honestly a lot of fun. I really did like that game a lot too. So hey, that's actually pretty cool that there is more stuff going to be released for it. I didn't know that there was going to be like a whole more routes and everything were going to be updated, because it seems like this one, I believe, if I remember correctly reading about it, there's going to be more, and like, there's different end routes and things like that. So I don't know. That's pretty cool. I do like that. That's pretty neat. So yeah, those kinds of games are like the only ones that I've been really like keeping an eye on, for stream wise. And then Elden Ring, for personal and also stream-wise. I love Elden Ring personally, so just very, very fun. And then another game, if you don't know, I've actually been getting into Gundam a lot recently. So I've been pretty excited for... Apparently they had announced that there was going to be a new Gundam game coming out that a lot of people are pretty excited about, so... I am excited for when that game comes out. So, those are really only the games that I've just really kept on my radar. Compared to that, there's really nothing else that I'm really interested in. Like, the whole, like, you can notice, not really into the whole Nintendo besides Pokemon, which that's not coming out for a while. But, yeah. I don't know. Like, I've heard of, like, isn't the Paper Mario the one, though, where you can make your own levels, or is that something else? Am I misremembering what Paper Mario is? I never played it. I've just heard people talk about it. But is that the one where you, like, make your own levels and things like that? Or is that all of them? Or is that Mario Maker? Is that something? Am I making that up? What's with that mouse? I have no idea what you're talking about. The mouse is beautiful and it is perfect. And even Martha is judging you. She is judging you. But yeah. Very red eyes. Is there red eyes in the background? All I see is up here. Were you talking about my eyes? Also, I'm the rosebud. You can hear my microwave. Also, I hear him out there. Hold on, let me bring him in. Turn-based RPG series. Oh, okay, never mind. I am completely not remembering what that is. I see. All right. Yep, nope. I think that's completely different from all the other Mario. Yep, I know Mario. I played, definitely. I'm amazing with that sensor. Oh god. Huh. Interesting. For not Mario players. Fascinating. I never would have thought Mario being an RPG series. Huh. Introduced. I don't understand. What's cat ears? Why? What about it? What do you mean? What do you mean by that? Boss and bunny? Boss and bunny? Who's in the Mario Ghost? Oh, okay. Okay, I was like. Are you missing a letter there, or what's happening? I think I'm like, that's weird that they would want to add that to bunnies, but I thought you were missing a letter there. Or trying to censor it. It's fine. You see what I'm trying to describe? Okay. Okay, let's see. I see what they were trying to do, but also I love her and her attitude that she looks like she... Oh god, wait, I don't like what else I'm seeing. I scroll too far in the image search. Making me have to shuffle in my chair now. There's one that I'm looking at that I can't show, I just remember it. Oh my god, I see, god, I cannot show this on stream, I can't, but, let's just say, they added a search in, assets, and, she can't see. Oh my god. I see. That is amazing. I love that. I love that and I hate it, but it's good. It's That's good. Stuff like that that makes me love Paper Mario games. You know, just make the opportunity for a lot of certain artists out there to be like, I will have fun. Oh my god. If you have no idea what I just looked at, then I would recommend looking up what I had just seen and you'll understand. Yeah, anyways. Yep, they put it there knowing. I think they 100% put it there knowing who their audience is. 100%. Without a doubt. Yep, they knew. See, that's why you said it's a Mario game made for not Mario players, and it's to help introduce that, which, you know, if I saw Pika, I'd love her too, but also oh, that art that I saw. Yep. Yep. I need to grab a drink. I don't have a drink. I just realized this is drinking leftover coffee that I have, which I have a little bit left. Delicious. 100% delicious. Feels like the old baby with Marley just walking around just randomly. I wish randomly she'd just start running in one direction, just make me scared, like, oh god, what's coming from the other direction? Random NPC, but she also looks like she has an attitude, which is just like the best thing. I don't know, what is it with characters, right? That like they have an attitude, but like it has to be like a very fine line, right? Like it can't go too over, but it needs an attitude and it can be like the best character ever, right? Like you have like your good old wholesome characters, you got your characters that are a bit scattered brain, like Bartlett over there, that are just lovable. Then you got like you got these other characters that just have like an attitude, and as long as it doesn't go too far, like most people just tend to fall in love with these characters. It's not the flirty attitude. That's not the attitude that I'm talking about. I meant the attitude of like a, how would I say? That are, a bit stuck up, I guess, maybe? Like, better than other people, and like shove it in your face, but like not too much kind of idea. Like, I don't like a rival, but not too bad of a rival feeling. But I don't know, like just that kind of like a smug. There you go. It's back exactly the smug face. I would say the very smug, like I got you kind of idea, right? Like, I think those kinds of characters are just amazing. Like the character that's coming up right now, just because I finally actually got around to watching this anime, which I read the books a while back, which I'm pretty excited for, if you don't know, called I'm in Love with the Villainous, which amazing book series. I actually really, really love the book series when they came out. Very, very good. But so they had recently, they made the anime, I think last year or something, so just barely finally I got to watching it. And like the character from there, like one of the main characters from there is like has like the bratty, higher, better than everybody kind of attitude, but like at the same time she's amazing, she's hilarious, she's the best. But it's like that fine line, it's that fine line of attitude that it's just like it they walk a very fine line. She's also very, very good. I don't know what it is. It's like they're funny, they're hilarious, like they're also like very cunning, and then at the same time they're just, I don't know, it's just something about those characters that are just amazing. Okay, and I think also like the whole clueless ones too, especially the ones that are very okay, I think the perfect example is probably Emu Red, where I love her to bits, but she is just very clueless, but also just very, like, a rich girl kind of idea, but also very, like, oblivious kind of idea. It's very good, very good. That's a question. Let's think video game characters, right? Video game, just video game characters, exclusively video games, not like adaptations from like movies, anime, or anything like that, just video games. What is, if you had to name one, what is your favorite video game character? From any video game, doesn't matter if I played it on the channel yet or not, who is your very favorite video game character? I'm curious, I wanna see. Because I need to think of my answer too. Let me think. Jason Hunter from Deus Ex. What is Deus Ex? I've always heard of it, but I've never actually known what that is. Like, what kind of game that is. What kind of game is it? Really? I'm surprised. I was not expecting Ting-chan. Oh. Okay. Yeah, I'm trying to think of mine. I'm thinking like through all the games that we played and everything. I would kind of have to agree with you on that. I can see she's just so chaotic. She's just such a chaotic, adorable mess. It's So, yeah, adorable and terrifying, I should specify. I would 100% accept that. I would accept that answer. I would. God, I don't know. It's like I'm going through all the different video games. Like at first, I would have said Cortana from Halo. I've always loved that character. She's been the best. She's hilarious, but smart and just helpful. My younger self, though, my very, very much younger self, my favorite would have been from Gears of War, Scourge. I loved him. He was amazing. When I was very, very little, I used to pretend to be him. We have this, like, measuring tape that, like, you know how you have the retractable ones? But this one was just, like, just normal, just nothing to it, measuring tape. And I would, like, wrap it like in my pants in the back and make it look like it was like a tail because I thought he had a tail, but doesn't really, it's just the skirt flaps, but I would pretend to be him. God. Oh, little me. My imagination. But I mean, he's really, really cool. If you don't know who I'm talking about, look up Scourge from Gears of War. Gears of War 2 he's from, but he should just show up. He's amazing. I love him. It's awesome. One of the coolest designs in a villain I've ever seen. Very, very good. Yeah, I would have said Cortana, but honestly, like, all the games that we played... Like, I really like Melina from Elden Ring. I like her whole attitude, her kind of, like, mysterious background. There's just so many theories about her and everything, and just her whole character throughout the game. Even though you don't see her a lot, just like how impactful she seems to be as a character with just as little interaction possible, and I'm like, what? But like going through them even more, there's been so many different video games. Like, Lily is another one. I mean, not just talking from the game, but from, like, as good a character stands, and too, and everything, and her whole interaction, and the whole idea of, like, figuring things out, and remembering her whole personality, and her will, and everything. Also, welcome. We're thinking about who our favorite character in any video game, exclusively video games, though, is. One of the best characters I've ever seen. Current sound. Toho? What is that? From video games, but their characterizations are clearly from the related material. I guess it's still video game, I'd say. Probably. Godwin. Sonic the Hedgehog. Human. Like, have 2 minutes of screen time. Helen is barely even a character. It's just crazy to think of being so highly of Melina. I think to me it's just that whole idea that, like, she's such a small character within the video game, but like the idea of everything that kind of seems to surround her. I mean, I'm not gonna spoil anything, but you probably know exactly what I'm talking about when I say that one of the big major parts about her and everything, and where a whole lot of theories stem from and all that, like, just like that kind of reveal and that, like, short part of the story kind of, like, changes a lot of everything. You're like, wait a second. I just like that whole concept of, like, something so minuscule could have actually just been so massive and be like, oh shoot, like, of a reveal and things like that. Assuming, obviously, it's just a lot of theories and all that, but I don't know. This is interesting. Also, Martlet decided to hide behind me again. Hold on. Go over there. What are your plans for any future stuff? for now, we just have a new game that's going to be showing up on the channel again, since we just finished a milk outside a bag of milk outside a bag of milk and inside a bag of milk inside a bag of milk. So we just finished those up, so there's going to be a new game on the channel that's another indie game. I don't know how terribly long this one is. I think it's semi-long, but not really kind of idea. Might be like one or two streams of content on that one, so we'll see about that. And then we have Persona as well, and then they're going on. And then obviously we have the anniversary stream that's popping up soon at the end of May, which I need to take a picture of the kit. I have it there. I need to take a picture of it, and I'll send it on the community tab for you guys, so you guys can get a similar kit if you wish to. And just gonna be a section on that of just helping me build a bracelet for the third anniversary. So yeah. Longest Persona. I mean, what, our last Persona game that we played was 50 something streams, I think 50. Are we in 50 or were we in 30? I might be getting confused with another game. No, I think we were in 50. I don't remember. Probably the merchant from Resident Evil 4. I do like the merchant. You're not wrong. I do like him. I like him a lot. A game theory. Literal, that description. For a background, I don't know. I don't have my headphones on. What's the music? It's Doomsday. It's because there's a song in the track that's actually a title that I just made for a recent stream. I think it's similar. It's similar to Nukem. So I was like, you know what? This is perfect. I didn't listen to the music at all, so I was like, hello, 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 welcome, Capizon. Welcome, welcome. But thank you, thank you, thank you. I started actually finally doing these chatting streams without having my headphones on, so I'm like, I have no idea what you guys are listening to. Hopefully it's fine. That's 44 streams, okay. Persona 3 should be much shorter. I mean, for now, until like the DLC comes out, right? Because that has apparently the answer or something like that. I forgot what it's called, but I'm thinking Higurashi with the answer arc. I saw that recently pop up on my Steam page, and I was like, man, I never thought about that game in a long time. I guess series, I should say. It's not just necessarily a game anymore, really. More, is it? Is Higurashi, if you know what I'm talking about, is it more popularly known for the visual novel or for the anime? I know there's also the manga, but which one is it? I mean, for me, I first knew it as an anime, not a visual novel, and then I figured out it was a visual novel, and I was like, oh, interesting. Even with the DLC, it should be shorter. Called the answer, just don't look anything about it, it'll spoil things. Yeah. I'm avoiding it. I have to be so careful to get thumbnails, like it's so difficult. Like now though, like what's nice about streaming in better quality is actually just being able to capture things from my stream and everything, so I can use those as the thumbnails most of the time instead of having to like look up and like different things and take pictures and be like, oh, we'll make this into something. But that's usually the hardest part, is always with having to make thumbnails. It's like, avoid everything. Like, I'll see a glance or something, I'm like, nope, I didn't see it. I don't know what that was. Not paying attention. Because, like, obviously, like, your eyes are drawn to things that are like, what is that? And I think those streams also went on for like Persona 5. I did a lot of streams where I think they were like four, almost like 5 hours, I think. I did a lot of streams before then that was a lot there. But then, now I've been trying to keep them to the 3 hour mark. Instead just of being like, oh shoot, we're in 4 or 5 hours. They're the only ones I really get the exclusive ones are the ones with the chatting and then with the viewers and, or with the members and all that. Take a screenshot of Pink Lady. You're better get, No, I'm not, as much as I know that that would probably get views, if I'm gonna be honest, we know it would. Nope. Just, nope. Nope. I'm very careful for that one. No worries. I understand. When you get busy, you just get tired and you're like, No worries. That'd be nice. But nice to see you again. It'd be nice to see you again often. But don't worry about having to attend like all the streams or be here for a long time or all that kind of stuff. Don't worry. God, I had woken. What the heck? Oh, I guess I punched my rib sometime earlier. Oh. Oh, God, you know how you, like, randomly just feel, like, a certain point on your body where, like, it hurts so bad to the touch? Yeah, I had that right now. Oh, like, I have one, like, weirdly, like, right on my right shoulder that I've had for a while. Like, it's very pinpoint, and it hurts so bad, and now I have one on my rib. Oh, ouchies. It's like, what happens at night, right? Like, what happens? What am I rolling into? The dogs are just punching me or something. I don't know why, but when I woken up earlier, like, my eyes were just completely blurry, and I was like, well, this is my day. Does anybody else have that issue? Or sometimes you'll just wake up and, like, I don't know, maybe you wake up with a headache and you're like, well, I'm gonna have this for the rest of the day. And sure enough, you do. Or, like, for me, a lot of it is either waking up with a headache or just waking up tired, or the main one that I have, like, right now is just, my eyes are just blurry. With glasses or no glasses, my eyes are just like, nah, I don't want to focus today. It's like, I will be blurry. I will be very blurry. It's always been tough, like, especially, like, when having to go out and about and having to, you know, read stuff and things like that, and I'm like, I can't see, and they're like, you have your glasses on. I know, but I still can't see. I don't know why my eyes don't do that sometimes. So it'll be like, it's like, it's almost like how I can describe if you wear glasses, when you take off, like, you wear your glasses and you take them off and, like, everything's, like, super blurry for a while. That's how my eyes are. But just with no glasses or yes glasses. They're just decide to be blurry sometimes. I don't like you, eyeballs. How many of you wear glasses? Or contacts? Need to, right? Like, have a prescription, I guess, of them. How many of you are never checked? Or you're like, I'm fine. I don't need them. Sit in the wall. Did I miss anything? That snap sound was. Didn't work. Shoot. Doka. Plan B. That's a good one. Makes things difficult to hear. Does it go randomly loud? Like I said, I don't have my headphones on, so I'll turn it down a little. There we go. I haven't listened to this track or anything. This is still by just the same person that we've been listening to this entire time, but... I don't think anything important happened. I'm just sitting here talking right now. I'm asking how many of you, like, wear glasses and you really need them, or is it just like whenever you like need to read something or like you need them at all or never checked or any of that. Glasses wear here. Like, I've never known anybody who doesn't need glasses. I think like majority of people need glasses, like they just refuse to wear them, like me. I don't know. I like, don't get me wrong, I like my glasses, I like being able to see, it's nice and everything, but also at the same time I don't like is this gonna sound weird, but you know when you're like just exhausted and you just want to like lay your head down or something, but if you have glasses on and you just go to do it just normally, they're in the way and you might break them and everything, so you're like, oh, I have to take them off and then put them away and then there you go. I told you I'm lazy. that's one of my problems. I just look at them, I'm like, do I have to? I have to. Like right now, I can tell you, I don't have my glasses on right now, which is probably why the tracking is... And that's the other thing too for me, is that like tracking is nice when I don't have my glasses on, but I should be wearing them. There you go. But, yeah. Glasses wear, glasses here. Always wear them. It's not an active decision. I can't see without them. And see, that's my problem. Like, one of my eyes are extremely blurry compared to the other one. I think I've said it before that I have one left. One is nearsighted and one is farsighted. So I have that issue where one of them, like is focusing and the other one is blurry. And they're just like, I don't know what I'm doing. And most of the time, it just causes a massive headache for me because... I have, you know, like, it causes, especially if you need your glasses and you don't wear them, it causes an issue anyways if you don't wear your glasses and are trying to focus on something, just making your brain trying to focus, all of that medical stuff, right? But, for me, though, what's interesting is that I actually can feel, like, pinpoint what part of my head, like, it's like, in the lower back, and, for instance, right now, it's the left side right now that is hurting. So I know it's one of my eyes are like, I'm drawing, and the other one's like, it's not that bad, but also the other one's having a heart attack. And the other one is dying. Put your glasses on. Yeah, basically, exactly like that, Ryan Man. That is the exact emoji I would use. Yep, that is exactly it. I probably need glasses for wanting to see beyond a walk away. I don't notice. I mean, for me, it's I've needed them like most of my life too and everything. But I've just been so lazy. Literally been so lazy and like. I'm sorry, but I don't have glasses. Has that ever been an issue? Until they balance out. Eyes good and one eye is bad. Wear a monocle. I should. Oh my god. How do I not have a... Why? And I had an excuse too. Why? I mean, it's not so much as that one eye is good, right? It's like for instance, like where I'm reading, one of my eyes are like, this isn't that bad. It's actually funny because if I close my eye, I can see it. My left eye can see chat pretty good. My right eye is like having a panic attack. It's like, what is happening? it's just so interesting. Like, but if I'm looking at something close, my right eye is pretty okay. My left eye doesn't like it. It's so weird. It really is. It really, really is. Like, I've always been interested in, like, I wonder if, like, I actually, like, you know, not latex. You know what I'm talking about. I can't remember the eye surgery, though, where it corrects your eye vision. I wonder, like, just how different it actually would be compared to, like, having that focus. Because, unfortunately, that is actually kind of the doctor was kind of telling me about with my glasses, that even though with the glasses, and yes, like, your vision continues to get worse and worse and worse and worse, but also, unfortunately, just because of my eyes being like that, it does cause a lot more strain for my brain to be like trying to focus and everything, because it still has to do that focusing idea and get used to that one of them are not the same as the other. So it's working overload, I guess, the reason why brain cells are down. So like I've always been curious, like if I had ever got my eyes fixed, it'd be like, would I not have a headache so often? Would it be like life-changing, like, oh my god, I finally have having a headache after like two days. I'm gonna be honest, that would be a miracle. LASIK, there you go. But yeah, I don't know, it's just always been something interesting. But glasses, wear your glasses, don't be like me. Don't be like me and not wear your glasses. Where Martlet is trying to hide behind me again. Go over there. Stop hiding. But yeah. But I should wear a monocle. Why do I not own a monocle? I should. I love monocles. I now want one. I want a monocle. Have you ever tried contacts? You see, once again, I am too lazy. I am too lazy to have to go through the process, and then they get messed up, and I need to fix them. And knowing myself, I would probably lose them. That is the issue. Also, I don't mind glasses, but at the same time, because like the thing is, like, you have to be careful not to fall asleep with them on, right? Because you can run into the issue that they do end up either getting lost in your eye or falling off. So it's like, I don't trust myself not to fall asleep accidentally with them on. I'm using one just in case. This is a medically subscribed monocle. To be an excuse to call someone a peasant. Oh my god. I would, that would be amazing. That would be 100% amazing. I would love that. You wonder, right? Is that why? Why did people wear monocles? I mean, yeah, it's like for your vision, like just to look close and everything. But you wonder if like for some people it was that they had the same problem with my eyes that they did, right? That one of their eyes seemed fine. Not really, but majority of the times that it was fine, and it was just like, oh. Or maybe there is like probably that issue as well, where one eye can be completely normal but the other eye is like, help. that would be a sucky condition. If I would I mean, what would be nice is that you wouldn't have to pay for the other lens, because that's the thing that's annoying, is have to pay for individual. Because god, if you don't know, like, the whole glasses processing making, like, so they have your prescribed lens and everything, right? Majority of times, it's just, like, cut from the same glass because it's gonna be for two lens. I, unfortunately, basically have an issue where it comes from two different glasses, so it takes extra time for them to make them because they have the two different lenses. So, it's also another reason why I don't like getting an eye exam and having to up my prescription, because it's like, yeah, I know, it's gonna take longer to get here, and the increase in cost because it's two different glass and all, I know. But like, imagine just having like to just only have like one, basically don't need the other one, like, you can just keep the, you can basically just wear a monocle. Thin little frames just holding on, nothing there, and then just pay for the one singular thing, or just have like a glasses and just have one just being like the, either just pop out the lens or just like leave it to the default one that they usually just have, which just has nothing on it, and then the other one that does have the prescription. God, why did my eyeballs not go that way? Why did they have to go funky? Why did they have to go the other way? Eyes are weird. Eyes are very weird. Like, of how easy they can be to pop out. Has anybody ever... Okay. Maybe I'm the only one who's ever thought about it. Because to me, that is one of the worst things that can happen, is your eyeballs popping out. I don't like that concept. Like, imagine the fear that your eyes just pop out and you can't, like... I don't know. God. And, like, they'll forever be protruding, right? They'll never really go back in properly. Ooh. Ooh. I don't like it. No, I don't like eyes. I don't. Like, for instance, I think I talked about, too, that when QA, unfortunately, she had got attacked by another dog. And when we had taken her to the vet and everything, like, we didn't notice it at the time because we were just so scared about what just happened. We were just rushing to get her wound closed and everything. But apparently her eyes had popped out a little bit. So now that I see her, she's all happy and everything. She acts like nothing happened. She really does. She's just like, do-do-do-do-do. But her eyes, like, protrude a little bit. And it's also a condition with pugs, unfortunately, as well. But her eyes just protrude a little bit, and you're like, stick those back in, please. Oh, it's creepy. It's very creepy. Very, very creepy. Glass. Oh, it's expensive. One get one glass. Right? That's what I think it is, too. I mean, they are right? They are medics in the eyes, but exactly, right? God, I don't know what I did to my rib. Like, even the stretch it hurts. So is it the muscle? No, it's the bone. What the heck did I do to hurt my bone? That's the things, like, I never understand. Like, when you get, like, bone bruises, especially, like, on my rib, I'm like, what the heck did I do? What did I roll into? What did I run into? That's, like, a weird part to get hit. Like, my shoulder, I can understand. I bump into everything, but my rib. Who punched me? Marky boy, did you punch me? Did you? I would be surprised. You can legally wear a top hat in public stores, trust me. You know what's interesting is I like hats. I do. I have a lot of hats. And my grandpa likes to give me all his hats too, so I love hats. Like, you know, normal caps, like what do they call them? Dad cap? Baseball cap? Whatever the heck it's called. Yeah, your normal hats, right? And then we actually have like 3 cowboy hats just from like one of the costumes that we've done like a long time ago, which was a lot of fun. But like those are the hats of one, but always wanted the top hat, like just like an actual proper top hat. Like, I also have like the newspaper hat, right? But a top hat, like not a fedora, but a top hat. Like, just the level of status to wear a top hat to where it's like, my head is too big that I need everybody to think that it's multi-layered. I just imagine. It's like one of those cartoons where they just have like the head is very long and like the hat goes to like cover it all and it just settles at the base. Oh god, like I just painted an image in my brain that I do not like, but oh, I love top hats. It's like the whole concept of like what a top hat is trying to do. It's like, really? I love them. They're amazing. Top hats are the best. Get a suit and everything. It gets your like three-piece suit, right? You got the button-up shirt. You got the little vest underneath. And you got the coat over. And yep. How many people like suits? I'm curious about that. I've always been told I'm weird. How many people actually like wear like suits? I don't know about wearing them. Wearing them too. Do you like to? Do you just like the look of suits? Do you like to wear them, or what is it? You gotta have a cigar and a cigar. Don't ever play Bloodborne. Isn't Bloodborne like only, unfortunately, on PlayStation, I think? Isn't that like one of the sad parts about Bloodborne? Is it on PC? I don't think it is it? True, it's the law. They're rarely made anymore. Silk top hats. Oh my god. I mean, silk itself is pretty expensive. They don't suit me. Oh, God. Alright, you know what? I'll give you that one. That one is actually pretty good because you didn't change the word to try to make it into a word that doesn't actually exist. You know what? That's a good one. That's a good one, Tiny Jinx. That's a good one. Also, on the moon, welcome. I guess, but... I have this thing that I've just been clicking the entire time in the background. I'm sorry. It's annoying. Wears many hats. I don't actually wear a lot of hats. I mean, usually when the sun is out and everything, and I just look at my hair and I'm like, nah. I mean, most of the time I look at my hair and I'm like, nah, you're fine as is. Ugh. Disconnected though. I mean, I have a PlayStation 4 actually. Now that I think about it, I do actually. We have one. Maybe we could play that. I mean, after we finish Elden Ring. Literally, I've been waiting this entire time and not played another Souls game because I have been waiting for the DLC to come out for Elden Ring. You don't understand how happy I was when that finally was announced. I was like, I knew it! I knew it was coming! Imagine if I played a Souls game earlier. Imagine it would take away from the delicious experience we're about to get in the DLC. Imagine. Imagine. God. It was worth the wait. Like, I can't believe, like, just how lucky I got from playing Persona 5. And then, all of a sudden, Persona 3, the remake, the reload edition, was announced. It was like, oh, perfect. I guess we already got another one we're planned on. Cool. That works. Like, luck, right? Luck. Very good. That's what it is. Anytime I play a game, like, they've always have to come out with something new, right? That's what it is. That's what it is. Oh, there is a lot of games where we have played it and they're like, oh, release soon kind of idea. It's like, what? I mean, for instance, like, I think Slay the Princess, we didn't wait that long at all for when the game finally came out. I was like, oh. Ooh. Yeah, I guess that happened. Yeah, it's that saying where it's like you wouldn't have a lot of money if you bet on things. The fact that it happened twice is kind of weird already. You have like 100 streams left before you finish all the other streams and the DLCs. I mean, don't get me wrong. I think the ones that have been on my radar have been Bloodborne and, and Dark Souls. Those two have definitely been the ones that have been on my mind. I know that there's three Dark Souls, I believe. So, that was pretty fun. The Sekiro was another one too, but I didn't know too much about that one compared to Bloodborne. That one is actually like, yeah, I'll play it, or just like, isn't that the parry one? Sorry, my brain was just remembering something. Isn't there one that is very heavy on parrying? Don't get me wrong, I like that. But also, tears. Marlet, can you stop hiding behind me, please? I've been watching you. Does anybody have any questions for me? Like anything whatsoever that you guys would like, I've been meaning to ask that or anything. I'm curious. It feels like it's been a while since I've just really been able to talk about things or just sit down and talk. I mean, like I said, Persona 3 provides pretty good opportunities for that, but, like, anybody have anything they've been wanting to ask or anything like that? Get it off their chest and be like, it's bugging me. Wanting to. Also, I like that you say 100 streams, and I'm thinking in my head, I'm like, make that 200. Knowing me, it might take me a while. The music's still going. Oh, did the music just stop itself? Oh no, there it goes. Okay. I was like, uh-oh. Problem about not having headphones on. I'm not paying attention to that. I'm going to assume no then. I'm going to assume all good on questions and nothing really need to be asked. Or are we all... are we all moving our brains and trying to get those cogs moving? How's the voice in your head doing? So, okay. So, this is... okay. Alright. Well, let's talk about this. Alright? Let's talk about this. So, maybe you guys have kind of... Maybe. It's kind of like the whole thing of like, you know, the whole lore on the channel and things like that, and like the hidden stuff that I've been hiding and all that. One of the characters, I do say one of them, is actually based off of, I will say, the voice, I guess, being Enamo, which, like I said, has a name and everything ever since that I've been little. I don't know, it's just, it's been, it's not like it's like a different personality, I guess, kind of, kind of in a way, like almost like, I don't know, like somebody to argue with, it's how I would say the whole relationship is. It's more of like that one of the things that were like, I should be doing this, and like the boy, and we'll just say Enamo, Enamo was just like, should you, you know, well, we just not do that, just not do it at the moment, like we have time. It's like, no, I should be doing this right now. It's like, really? Do you have to? I mean, come on, there's other things to be doing. It's like, can you shut up? And then other times it's like, no, I can't, and I won't, and I don't plan to. How many more times can I bug you? It's basically how the whole relationship goes. I don't know. I attribute it to the idea that ever since, because I ever when I was little and everything, I'm an only child, and when I would be by myself, I'd create like a playmate kind of idea, right? And I think that just playmate just kind of has like its own personality to make it more unique from the idea, right? Unique to the idea of like you're actually playing with somebody else that isn't yourself. So it was kind of like that whole concept of like being slightly annoying, but also like slightly annoying and just always wanting to be contradicting, but then at the same time like actually shows like genuine care and genuine like concerns for things, like especially I would say like when I was younger during my rougher times and things like that, was mostly kind of just there like, hey, let me tell you a story, and coming up with stories and scenarios and being like the active character in the story, and kind of like my own placement for being in the story was her kind of idea. That's kind of how I would say that whole thing is. is that kind of relationship, just something that has stemmed from my childhood and being alone and playing and things like that. And even when I was younger, especially playing like open world, I say open world, but just more like just running around chaotic games or even just shooter games, like I would come up with like scenarios and things like that. And for me, it was always like Enamo was always the character that I was playing as. And like almost I would actually, perfect example is kind of like the whole idea of like, if you don't know Halo, this is not gonna make sense to you, but the whole Cortana and Master Chief relationship, like Cortana's not an actual physical being and not actively like next to Master Chief picking up items and all that kinds of stuff, but rather like a voice in his head that's talking to him, giving him advice, telling him about things and all that kind of stuff, while Chief is like, where I guess you could say Cortana's like the co-pilot and Chief is basically the pilot that controls his body and everything, right? That's kind of like how I always like imagine that scenario. Even with like you could say with Enamo just going about in my day and everything, it's like kind of like, what does that look like over there? And it's like, nope, we're not doing that today. We're just focusing on getting the item because we need to get home soon. be like, come on, just a little bit. Let's just go over and just check out what it's going to do, see what it is. And maybe it might be interesting to come back later for it. And be like, no. And they're like, hey, but maybe this person would like to go see it. And you'll see what it is. And it's like, I'm going to kill you. It's that relationship, basically. So, yeah, that's how I would say it is. All right, goodbye, Killer was here. Thank you so much for coming. Thank you. Thank you. But, yeah, I'd say that's how voice, maybe it's not normal, maybe it's not normal at all, but like I said, I think it came from the whole idea of just being younger and, not really having people to play with and coming up with scenarios and stories and things like that. I've always been that kind of person where I'll just sit there and just start thinking about, different ideas, different story bits, different things like that. I've always had to get the brain moving in that way. And like I said, music, it does not help. Anytime I hear music, my brain's like, thinking time? It's like, no. It's called just having a blank mind, not thinking. And then it starts to think. So that's how I would say that is. Anybody have been reading any books recently? Like, is there any book that's you just started picking up recently or been wanting to pick up again? Like, maybe an old book or something you've been wanting to pick up or something that looks interesting or you are reading right now? Anybody? Like, any kind of book. Manga, novels. Not textbooks. if you're in school right now, not that. I'm talking about, like, for enjoyment, I guess. Anybody reading any books at the moment? While I ask that question, I'm actually gonna go grab a drink real quick. I do not have a drink. Break time while you guys are also answering the question. I'll be right back.
back. Sorry, it's like the thing wasn't open, and I'm like, of course it's not open. Alright. Finish reading Kipling's The Jungle Books. Going to a fire up in the deep. Huh. Nice. I'm assuming those are like novels and everything. What am I reading? Hold on, I'll answer that in a second. Look, Electro. Don't worry about it, don't worry about it. It's okay, it's okay. She's just sitting there massively. Sorry, sorry. The online manual? But really long pages back? Yeah, no, I don't mean like just physical. Like you can be reading it online and everything. I know some people prefer that, which honestly I agree. It's just easier to transport around and everything. But you know, that counts too. What am I reading? Well, from watching the anime I was talking about called I'm in Love with the Villainous, I looked at the books and I'm like, you know what? It's been a while since I read it. And apparently there's even more books to the series. So I was like, oh, shoot. Okay. Looks like I'm going to start rereading those books and then getting a hold of those new ones too. So that's what I've been going through again right now. It's cool because they have the light novels and then they have the manga of them, which I have not... I think as I mentioned that before, I kind of like that concept sometimes where you'll have the light novels and then you'll have the manga. I mean, they also do like the web novels and all that too, but I like that idea because you get to see it like actually like shown and everything, where I prefer when you read the novels first and then read the manga, because you see it like you already have like an idea, like an imaginary like scenario for that. And when you're reading it, to me, like most of the time it feels like you're kind of reading like a similar story but also different, because it's actually drawn and everything, and some of the dialogue pieces are changing and all that. So I'm pretty excited for that. But I've been rereading I'm in Love with the Villainous and then continuing on more, which god, I didn't realize how thick those books are. For instance, let me go. Two, and I thought they stopped at 1 or 2, but apparently there's like 5, I think the 5th one coming out, or 6th one. So the first one is how many pages long? First one is 268 pages, and it's a pretty big book. It's not like a normal standard size book. It's a pretty big book. And then the other one is even thicker. That is, let's see, it is 416 pages. Oh god, I didn't realize how thick that was. Apparently there's more too, so I'm like, I got a lot of reading to do. It's been a long time since I've read, so I'm pretty excited to get back into reading. I've been wanting to, I just haven't had the time. Nothing had really interested me at the moment, so I'm excited. It's essentially Disney-based. Jungle Books. Okay. Yeah, okay. I know what you're talking about. I'm not being God's lackey. Ah, I see. Okay, that's pretty cool. that sounds pretty cool. I like that. That's actually pretty good. I like that title. Those are pretty good. I don't know. I've always liked reading. I mean, I literally have an entire bookshelf in my room and accumulating bookshelves that I've just makeshift made. I don't know. I've always liked books. I've always liked reading. They're just so fascinating. I like stories. They're good. I like stories. I like them. They're just, stories are amazing. Especially when you make like a good story. It's just, god, it's, you, like, especially, I like books that you can reread again just because of how good it was, and there's like details that you don't remember and you're like, oh my god, I forgot
forgot about that. Like, when I was watching the anime, there I was like, could recall like bits of stuff that happened in the books and everything. But then there were some things that I completely forgot. And it's, I know it's not for the sake of like, oh, they did something different from the books or anything like that. It was actually something that I had forgotten. I was like, oh yeah, I remember that now. Where I'm like, now reading it, why Martlet's trying to go off the edge. Martlet, no, I see you over there. She's trying to go into the other monitor. No. You'll destroy the world if you do that. But no, I've always liked books. They're just, they're good. They're very, very good. Very fun. I like them. They're good. I like them. What about like TV shows or anything? TV shows, movies, all that kind of stuff. Though I read more manga nowadays than original literature. And honestly, I mean, I don't see a problem with that. I think at the end of the day, you're still reading, right? It's still reading. It's still like for me, when reading manga, it's like the idea of like imagining a person's voice or something. I don't know if you guys do that. Do you guys imagine what somebody sounds like, or do you just read it in your own voice? Right, that's kind of cool. Like, you think about it, when you're reading something and you read like a dialogue piece, you never really realize like, am I making up a voice in my head that I think this sounds like, or is it my own voice that I am using and not really trying to think up of another voice to read it? Right? I don't know. Especially with the series, I'm excited to go try to find the mangas later. Because I like that. I like the concept of seeing like different perspectives on a story that I really enjoy. It's just good. It's just very, very good. LeBron and what I read. I hear a voice when I read. Is it just me again? Is it just me being weird again? Voice that matches the character, right? Like, it's interesting. Like, you don't actually think about it. Like, for me, yes, I make up the voices in my head and everything, what I think they sound like and all that kind of thing. Like, when I was watching the anime, I was like, that is not what I imagined they sound like. But you know what? It still works. But now hearing their voices, and when we read the light novel again, I'll be like, oh, I say light novel, but when I pick up this book, you are not a light novel. You are huge. You are just a book. God, I didn't realize how giant this book. Do I have like the ruler or something? I used to. Do I still have one in here? No. I'm gonna try to see if I could, kind of try to measure just how giant this book is. It's big. I have to hold it with two hands. Like, okay, it's not a really good comparison because I have tiny hands, but basically, like, I can hold book in between, like, in my palms with my hands on each side of it, and my thumbs don't even come close to connecting. This book is huge. But very good. Very, very good. That's why I'm kind of like also thinking, like, if I buy the next novel, how is it like, because the second novel is double the size from the first one, so I'm like, is it gonna just keep doubling? That would be fun, right? Try to actively make your, like, if you have a series and you have the novels and everything, try to make your every installment that happens double the pages in the previous one. That would be funny. I would enjoy that. I would. That would be a good trick by the writer and the editor. I'm trying to read more. See, that's for me. I started off reading a lot of novels first. I read a ton of novels. I had always just read novels, and then eventually, I think I mentioned it, I ran into Tokyo Ghoul, which was my first manga. Because I saw Toka on there and I was like, hey, I've seen that character before. I wonder what the story's about. And ever since then, I have been taken over. But yeah, and then that's when I started getting into the whole manga things and started reading more of them. Like, I used to have... Blue Exorcist was one of them, but I had given those away because I just didn't really enjoy the story anymore. And then just, like, a lot of other ones that I just started accumulating, and I was like, oh, this is pretty good. Oh, this is pretty good. This is pretty good. Because, like I said, I used to just read normal novels, Halo being one of them, Gears of War, and then just random ones. Like, I actually read the Maze Runner series, and then... Because I actually had to read those for school, which was pretty funny. And then I actually ended up enjoying them, that whole stuff. Just other random books, like the one by Haruki Murakami, and then stuff like that. And then eventually just turned into manga and then a mixture between the two. And then enjoying light novels more than I enjoy mangas. All that good stuff. Is that... what is that bird? Joining the stream and being like... What is walking on the screen? What is that? This is Marlet. Say hello to Marlet. She's a good... Right, she's gonna go on top of me. She's a good bird from Undertale Yellow. Fantastic game, by the way. She's adorable. Don't worry about it. She's a permanent addition unless I forget about her to the channel. Marley, don't go behind me, please. Can I throw her? I technically could. Alright. Highly, entirely recommend you to drop everything and watch ReZero. You're actually forced to do it now. I tried! I told you I tried, and I don't like the second season. It's too slow. I'm sorry. Bye, Electro. Bye. Thank you so much for coming. Bye. And good luck. Hi, Martlet. Martlet. I just like the idea that I can just pick her up and wee. My god, imagine. Wait, I have an idea. Also, can I not highlight the message? There you go. I have an idea. Can I find all these of all the waifus I've ever had on the channel? Right? Can I find one of Makoto? Can I find one of Monica? I'm sure I can find one of Monica. I'm sure there's one that exists. And then, let's see. I probably can't find one of your reign. Maybe Lady Dimitrescu, although I kind of doubt it. And then Marley will just be the exception. Marley's just because she's Marley. That's why she gets the spot. But that's what I was thinking. Like, imagine just have a Monica walking around. God, I miss Doki Doki. I do. I miss that game so much. I want more. I want more Doki Doki. Come back. Come back, Doki Doki. I miss you. You're such a good game. Ugh. Nah, I'm sad. I don't even know if there's, like, any, like, good fan games of Doki Doki that are good. Like, I mean, like, good spicy ones. Like, not that kind of spicy. Wait a second. Hold on. Not that kind of spicy. Like, kind of similar, like, with how Undertale Yellow is for, I mean, literally the only fan game that I have actually played with Undertale. Actually, I played Five Nights at Freddy's ones, but like a good one, like a very good one where like kind of captures the same essence, but it's just a good story, right? I don't know if there's any good ones. You're kidding, but just Monica. I'm 100% behind you on that bandwagon, okay? Instead, actually, I'm kicking everybody out, all right? Monica's mine, okay? That bandwagon is mine and mine alone. Everybody else out. Those of you that played, you know what I'm talking about with Doki Doki Literature Club. I've played it or seen people play it. Who was your first character? Like, the very, very first character. What character did you like? Not knowing anything about it. Nothing. Just out of all the girls, which one was your favorite? Which one did you like a lot? You can have Natsuki. No! I mean, I don't mind Natsuki, but also, no! Also, yes, Doki Doki is amazing. If you didn't play Doki Doki, it has actually played watch it. I did. That's actually the first one I actually played on the channel. Then I played the original on my own. since it's basically the same content except the stuff that it messes with your computer. Which essentially the other one does too, but yes, I did. The only... You're not wrong! She's technically the only sane one! You're not wrong at all about that one. You are not wrong. Where was Monica from the start? I took with Sayori. Oh my god. You and I had similar paths, I believe. Yeah, Monica was my first choice. And then I had to pick, I picked Sayori. She was my second choice. Or who was your third choice? Who was your third choice? Who did you have to pick in the second part? Pick an actor, yes. I should... Talking about Doki Doki, no! It's anchored you now! No. Thank you so much for coming. Thank you. But you're not wrong about Natsuki. You're not wrong at all. Has evolved into Yeetlet. Yeetlet, go! It's like a Pokemon. God, I wish... Mike, that would have been perfect. And my cursor was like a Pokeball. Just go like, Yeetlet, go! Yuri was second oct. Oh my god, I think we had the exact same playthrough. I think I did the exact same thing on my first run of that game. Yep. Loved Monica, but couldn't pick her, so I had to choose Sayori, which I didn't mind. She was my second choice, and then after that one, I ended up choosing Yuri. I agree. Not like I dislike Natsuki, but she's just not my type. True. I agree with you on the Natsumi part. And the same thing with Yuri too. I think what just drew me to her was just the whole idea that she liked the whole novels and things like that. And at the time, I was a lot more into novels than I am into manga. I mean, still, I actually prefer novels. Like I said, I like light novels compared to manga. I just always have. Always liked that concept. But, yeah. And I like Yuri's poems too. I do. Though Monica's is amazing. Who was your favorite poem writer? Out of anybody, who was your favorite poem writer? Out of everyone. I feel like Monica's a hard one just because of what she was talking about, but... Which is good enough to be fantastic. Suicide, very kind character. Natsuki. Sorry, I think you mean Monica. For me, I think Sayori's was probably my favorite writing style. I did like the way she wrote hers. Very, very good. Because of the little cloud one. Yeah. Yep, exactly. Yep. I like that one too. I think that was the one that was... Ooh. Oh, that would hurt. That would hurt a lot. Marlin, can you not be in the corner? Please? Please? No, not over there. Over there. Oh god, I just beheaded you. I'm so sorry. Feeling apart or something, which got to me. I know which one you're talking about. Just trying to make everybody happy. I think it's the jar or something like that, right? It's to do with the jars that she gives a little bit to everyone, but that she doesn't have enough for herself and all that. I think it's something like that. Yeah, she's good. She's very... I liked hers. Those are very, very good. But I like her writing style, but I also like Monica's, where she played around on the usage of like the page. I really like that because like it created like an art style within the whole idea of the poem, right? Where using like the placements of your words and like kind of what you're making. God, who makes things like that? There's a very famous poet, I guess. God, I can't remember his name. But he makes a lot, he makes his poems like that a lot too, where he does it, he plays around with the space that he has on the page. But yeah, I really did like that one. I like that. You can combine that with, like, Sayori's, the way she writes. That'd be perfect. That'd be really good. I mean, she sort of does the same thing, right? She uses the whole space, but, like, I think the way the Monica did was, like, kind of, like, making, like, kind of, like, shapes and making swerves and everything. Is she really good? Alright, goodbye, Electro. Thank you so much for coming. Ooh, nice. Alright. Well, bye. Thank you so much for coming. Enjoy. I like that you're trying to convince us too about that one. actually, that's something pretty good. When Yuri wrote me that Zodiac killer poem, you're not gonna lie. God, do you guys remember that one poem with the tea stain? God, man, she needs to be careful with the tea. I remember when I saw that, and it was such a shocker. Like, I couldn't believe it. I couldn't actually believe it. What was everybody's most shocking poem, I should say, out of anything? What was the shocking poem? I would assume everyone's gonna say probably one of the first ones, right? The one I would say with Sayori and all that. But what is everyone's most shocking poem? We know what game this is. We know what game this is. You know what I mean. For me, I think it's gonna have to, as much as that beginning one with the whole thing where I guess it really starts to go off the rails with Sayori and everything. Yeah, that was pretty traumatizing. That will forever be traumatizing. But I think the one that takes the icing on the cake, as they say, is probably the one with the tea stain. The tea, you know, the tea stain. I just couldn't believe it. Like, not even the context of what was in the poem. Like, it didn't matter. Like, nothing mattered at that point. When I just looked at it, I was like, that's not what I think that is it? that was just traumatizing in so many ways. God. that was creepy. Get out of my head, get out of my head. God. That one, I think when that happened in the game, that was just really the moment of, oh shoot. Really just, oh shoot, what have I gotten myself into? What is happening? What is anything that is about to happen? It was kind of funny. So it's a bit of a story time. So after we had played that game and everything, and I wanted to see what the, because if you don't know, I actually played the Doki Doki Literature Club Plus version first before even playing the one on the desktop. And so when I finally decided I wanted to see what the original one was like, I actually had my father with me, and I told him just to come play it with me. I knew it was gonna happen, right? And I knew he would like it. But at first he was like, what are we playing? What are we doing? Like, just very weirded out by it. And then when it finally just really got to what it was going at and everything, that was, my father was just kind of looked at me, was like, oh shoot. I was like, yeah, now you know why I love this game. Like, honestly, just out of all games that I've played, I think I have to say that Doki Doki Literature Club is probably one of my favorite games. Just out of anything, playing was one of the best. Like, if there's any game that I wish I could just redo again and have like a fresh experience on and everything, it's that game. It's 100% that game. It was such a good game. Really, really liked it. The suspense and the surprise and the shock and the trauma. It was all good. It was all very, very good. I wish I could redo that experience. It was very good. But yeah, so yeah, I think that that T1 was like I said, don't get me wrong, the whole thing with that and then the whole thing that Monica would do, I can't remember, like something like you scroll down at the very end of her poem, because you know she likes to play with the paper, right? She likes to play with the space that she has and everything. You scroll down to the bottom and she's like, can you hear me? Like that was that moment of like running away, but also it's in my computer. Like that was honestly those were pretty good too. God. Okay, so besides the poems, what was everybody's most shocking event? Out of anything that happened, like the shocking event, like certain part of the story that was the most shocking thing ever. What was it? What was everybody's most shocking point? I feel like, once again, I feel like I know what most people are going to say, but what is everybody's shocking event? It hit almost everyone who wasn't prepared. Imagine! You were playing this game not for what it is, right? Like, I think it kind of got word out about what kind of game that this was and everything, but like, imagine the first people to really experience this game not going into it with the knowledge that something's up. Like, why is this game out of all the other visual novels so popular? Like, imagine being one of the first people to play it. Like, that reaction I would love to see, right? Like, somebody who enjoys these kinds of games and going to play it, like, imagine the shock that somebody went through when playing that game. Imagine. God. Another reason I like that called Power Shoujo. You might want to check it out. Ooh, okay. Power Shoujo. Spicy in there. But I turned it off anyway, that's fine. Oh, okay. So you can turn it off. Okay, good. I was like, you can turn off the spiciness, right? Natsuki Easter egg, I believe it was. Oh, is that the one in the second act when reading her poem? And then all of a sudden just... And then she runs at you? Yeah, okay. At least we had the same... Okay, we had the same thought about that one, too. Yeah, no. That was traumatizing, too. That was honestly probably one of the biggest, scariest jump scares I had ever had. That was the worst. Yeah, that was bad. That one was really, really bad. Honestly, I think compared to that one... Or the whole thing with Yuri. I still remember my reaction to the one with Yuri. I still remember that one. That was terrifying. I think this was quite literally my reaction. That was my reaction. I was just so dumbfounded. I couldn't believe what just happened. I just literally just sat there like, huh? What? Huh? What just happened? Oh. Like that, like, at least, like, I'm gonna be honest, like, I hate to say it, but like, at least with Sayori, you know, with the poem and everything and kind of that stuff, like, I mean, yeah, you're not expecting it, but, like, it's not as unexpected as just randomly out of nowhere, oh, okay, yeah, that one just left me with no words. That one was just, oh, God, I still remember that. That was just, that's it, as like, I thought this game couldn't surprise me anymore, and lo and behold, it did. And that was only the beginning. Not even getting to act three. God. But yeah, no, I love that. I love that. Apparently there's like something pretty cool about like if you're recording it or like streaming the game on the computer, where it'll actually, if you're in act three, spoilers, you're in act three, I mean, it's been spoilers by now already, so, there's a part where Monica will actually be able to detect that you are recording the game, and yeah. Yeah, it is actually a pretty cool event. If you haven't seen it, I'm sure somebody has a video of it or something. It's pretty cool. It's really, really cool. I wish the game did that more often. I would love the game to do that as often as possible, right? Like, just throughout the game, she just randomly, I don't know, either make it to where she'll, like, randomly show up in your chat or something, or, like, a computer kind of idea showing up in the chat, or, messing even more with your computer, or that kind of idea of like, hey, you recording right now? Hey, what you doing there? Hey, that kind of stuff. God, I remember when I saw that video, that I was like, the developer really thought of everything, didn't he? The weekend bit, yeah. I think the weekend bit, the one with Natsuki, obviously. Sayori part 2 is pretty bad, but I think like the most like so confusing and shocking, like you were suspicious, right? I think I kind of wish the game did a little bit better in not making you so suspicious of Monica so early on. That was kind of my only thing, is like when she kind of got to like the real part, it wasn't so big, right? Because she already was kind of dropping a lot of hints, especially if you noticed the whole thing in your files and everything pretty early on. It was kind of like in your face that, oh yeah, oh yeah, she's doing something, there's something up. But I kind of wish like it went like a little like eased off of it and not really make it too much of where like your computer files are going all weird and it's all attributed to one person and all that kind of things. Like, I wish the whole reveal of her showing the, like, editing box just kind of showed, like, ding, and you're like, oh, shit. Kind of idea. Oh, the weekend I was talking about was a year weekend after year. Yeah, no, wait. Are we talking about the same one where she got a little... you know, stabby? That's all I can say. Is that the one you're talking about? Or are you talking about like the hangout event from the first act? Which weekend are we talking about? When she got a little too, happy? Or a one where you just hang out with her? Yeah, the long winky. Okay, yeah. That one's bad. That one's really bad. But yeah. Yeah. But yeah, I think that would be my only thing with the game, is just I wish they didn't, like, the whole, like, when Monica reveals herself, it's like, I kind of figured out that it was you this entire time. Like, it's good, kind of, I mean, it was, don't get me wrong, it was still pretty shocking, like, for her to just kind of show up in your face and do it, and it's like, oh, she's not hiding. she's done. But I do wish like that reveal was kind of a bit hidden, I guess, not so just in your face kind of idea, just like constantly pin. I mean, it did good at the pacing of before getting to that point of being like, oh, it's her, kind of idea. But yeah, no, it's a very good game. Very good game. And I also, it's like, it's weird, right? Did you guys still like Monica even at the end of the game? And I mean the end. Like, you got all the endings. Did you still like Monica at the end? For those of you that liked Monica at all. If you didn't like Monica, then, well, this question is not for you. But even at the end of everything, did you still like Monica, or did she go lower on the totem pole? Did she lose her spot of number one? it's like, well, until she sang to me, then. I know what you're getting at, her lyrics and everything, right? I know what you're getting at, but. I like that. So, you know, she sang to me and everything, just heard her voice, and I was like, ooh, I am love struck again. but yeah. God. I'm so lonely in my heart. Yeah, God. That was just like such a difficult part. It really, really was. And then I think, like, when she kind of just like revealed when you know, finished the job kind of idea with her. And she just kind of reveals that, like, well, I didn't really get rid of him because, you know, I couldn't really do it kind of idea. Or that was just kind of like, oh, no. And I just really did just undo her, didn't I? I think that's the part, right? Is like, she's like, well, I didn't necessarily do what you did. I didn't get rid of her at them at all, like you did to me. Technically, right? Because you could still kind of recover it. Which is, I don't know if anybody ever did that, but spoilers, right? Basically, I believe, like, once you delete her and everything, and she restarts the world and all that, and if you try to put her back into the game files, she will tell you to please stop, that she doesn't want to be a part of this anymore. Like, oh! Like, that heart, like there at that moment, you can really tell that she just really just... She regretted everything that she did, and like I said, I think I talked about it a lot when we played that game, that I really can understand. I mean, you can't, right? You can't really understand where she's coming from. Sort of, kind of can't, right? If you believe in the whole idea that you live in, like, a simulated universe, maybe in a way you can, but honestly, nobody can really understand how she feels. So, it was that kind of idea that, like, what would you do? Like, that idea of freaking out and wanting to be, like, actually happy and, like, live, be part of something that makes your life not just seem so meaningless, like, because it's simulated, and that whole idea, it's like, ooh, yeah, I get it. And yeah, in the song, like, it really does kind of explain, like, her motive as to, you know, why she did it. As to what on earth could possibly possess her to do it. And you know what? I'm gonna have to say it's a valid excuse. Because, I mean, what's interesting is that once again, there's whole spoilers for this game, but at the ending, if you actually do all the endings, basically what I'm talking about is the good ending. If I remember how you got it, is you're supposed to get every single cutscene, so you have to do, like, multiple playthroughs, I believe, to get all the cutscenes and all that, and then when Sayori kind of takes control instead of going all crazy like Monica did and all that. Although, if I will be honest, Sayori went off the deep end far quicker than Monica did. She was just like, nope, no fluff, we're doing this. Which I find hilarious, is that Monica at least was trying to keep it together, where Sayori's like, nah, no, not at all. That kind of whole concept. But I was kind of interesting, right, to see the whole idea where she's like, and she still carried her personality. She was like, well, yeah, she did do bad. Yeah, I'm not gonna do it because you made everybody else happy, but yeah. She is pretty terrible, isn't she? Like, that part of the ending, like, I don't know. I for me, that doesn't feel like the proper ending to the game. It feels like the original ending, the main ending you get, is actually, like, the proper ending to the game. That kind of idea is like, nope, no insanity, nope, no. It's like, let's stop this right now. I mean, either way, in the end, it just ends. Also, the hints or something beyond the dude, especially when it comes to... Oh yeah, definitely in the plus version. Wish! Where is the next game? Where is it? When is it? Maybe it's already out and nobody's aware. But where is it? Mm-hmm. New Patina, right? God. I remember going through like a whole deep dive within that game and everything, and like checking everything out and going through it all and all of the stuff. God, that was good. That was very, very good. I want more. I miss it. I do. I really do. But yeah, no. It was good. It was a very good game. Very, very good game. Loved it. Very good. Very good. Anyway, so before we end the stream, does anybody have any questions that they would like to ask? Anything at all? Anything related to do with me? Stream? Ideas? Anything like that? Anybody got any questions? Are we all good? So I can talk about Okie Dokie all day long. Just a fantastic game. Really, really, honestly, to me, one of the best games I have ever played on stream for multiple reasons. Just good. Just very good. Anything at all? Or are we all good? I'll give it a little bit. We'll give it, what time is it? We'll give it like a minute. Give it a little longer. Hasn't been a minute yet. Still waiting. Alright, I'm already gonna say that probably no, that we're all good. Alrighty. Well, anyways, though, I think that's gonna be it for this stream. It's a good time to catch up and everything and see how everybody's been and all of March and all that good stuff. So, yeah. If you celebrate Easter, then happy Easter soon. We don't celebrate Easter. And happy day. I was trying to think, I'm like, then what? go get some chocolate. Eat some chocolate. Enjoy it. Just have some chocolate. Just make it a special day, right? I guess. Don't celebrate and just make it a special day. Eat some chocolate. And yeah, just have a good old time and all that stuff. Let me go ahead and change the schedule. Say bye to this Marlet. Alright, well, Marley doesn't want to say bye. That version of Marley doesn't want to say bye, I guess. That's fine. I can't have sugar. My mind is blank. Enjoy a glass of milk. For good old milk inside a bag of 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 milk inside. Or, you know, watch one of your favorite videos. Watch something you enjoy. Watch my old streams. Go watch them. Go watch all of my older streams and all that good stuff. Watch the content. Watch all the good stuff. All right. Watch it. Watch it. Go watch it. Go watch my old stuff. It's good. Go. Do it. Go do it. Alright. Have some... Oh, there's sugar-free candy. Go have that too. But also watch my older stream. Go watch that too. You know, I just realized, I never say to check out my other streams. I never say to click the like button. I never say to click the subscribe button. Go do it. Ow! I just smacked my finger. This is why I never say it. But go do it. Go do it. Go. Oh, I don't even know the whole routine. Go click like button, subscribe, comment something. I don't know. Apparently that does something too. Comments and streams do something. I don't know what they do. Algorithm maybe? Maybe that's what that does. And watch older streams. Am I convincing? Look, I don't do that kind of stuff. I should. It would help out the channel a lot, but also I'm too lazy. But yeah, but anyway, so go do that. Go support the channel that way. If you liked what you saw and liked what you see and now the stuff and wanna help out, then go do that. Do it. Please. Beg of you. The begging will start. Also, we need to take a look at this abomination. Ready? God. I don't like that it just stares. Like, I've literally been hiding it with the YouTube chat, and it just... Just go. Just... Yeah. Perfect. Beautiful. Alright, anyways. Go ahead and switch on over to the side. Oh, that's the wrong one. There we go. There we go. Alrighty. Anyways, though. Anyways. Smack your keyboard and pray. There's a 2 year old. Yeah, no. I'm putting up the YouTube chat again over there so I can distract it. Guys, save me. Save me. Alright. But anyways, though. Let me hide myself real quick. So this is the updated schedule for next week. Just a reminder again that stream on Sunday will be on Sunday, not Saturday. So do pay attention to that for those of you that have a different time and different day and all that kinds of stuff. So that'll be over on Sunday, not Saturday, Sunday this weekend. So just a heads up about that. And we'll be picking up Persona 3 and another new game that should be some fun times, some good old times. And I've been pretty excited to play. It's something I've been having once again on my playlist for a while. So we'll see. My wish list, not playlist, my not music. But yeah. But you guys know what you guys should do is go watch my own videos. I don't know. I'm trying to think of like what's a good segue to actually, you know, help promote the channel and things like that. I can't. It's too hard to think about. Oh. But yeah, so it'll be some fun times next week. And also, this is it for March. Goodbye, March. Never want to see you again. Oh, I have to see it every year, though. And hello, April. I don't remember if you're any better, but yeah. Yeah. Exactly. Thank you. Anyway, you should like... I mean, you should... What Moises Sanchez said. I can't say it. Anyways, you should comment, like, and subscribe. There you go. And watch my old videos, my old streams. They're pretty good. I recommend checking out Outer Wilds. It's a very good series. If you like story, very good story. If you like funny moments, that's a good one too. Or if you want a really, really fantastic and sad story, then go check out the Amori stream. That was a pretty good one as well. Pretty interesting one as well. Very interesting. But yeah. But anyways, though. Anyways. And so, yeah, smash the like button. I'm sorry, just hit the microphone. No, smash my microphone. Smash the like button. Exactly. Click it. Go click it. Go spam it. Just make sure just stay on the like one and not on the unlike one. All right? Good. Or, yeah, exactly. Or if you missed the pain, go check out House. Good story. Lots of pain. Go check that out. Or go also check out Elden Ring. We're going to be picking up the what the heck are we picking up soon? The DLC for it soon. So we're going to be picking up that. Or, you know, we were just talking about Doki Doki Literature Club. You want to see very baby me, very little tiny me? That was very, very new and very green face of this whole thing. Yes, I had green face. Go check it out. go check out Doki Doki Literature Club Plus. Very, very fun stream. Good. Very good. Extremely good. Very good. Also, go check out Slay the Princess. The very good story. Very well done. Traumatizing cheese. Lots of cheese. Or go check out Baldur's Gate 3. Recently just finished that game. And it was a very fantastic story and everything. And I will... Then trust me when I say I will leave you traumatized. In all the good ways. Anything else we need? What else were we supposed to do? It was a good promotion for the older ones. Or catch up on streams that you haven't seen just yet. If you're wanting to get into Persona 3 while it's still going on live and everything, then go spend your day and spend the rest of your week and everything like that going to watch Persona 3. We're still playing that game, so you guys can still catch that. Perfect. I'll still leave you traumatized, though. No worries. Yeah, I think that's all pretty much it, too. Like, subscribe, comment, check out old stuff on the channel. Leave a company if you want to see a multiplayer game. Those have a lot of funny moments in it and very good times. I was playing with those of you that are part of the membership. So, fellow voices of the void, some good times in that one, also some time playing with my friend. Go check out those streams too. Alan is actually a pretty funny guy, so yeah, we play sometimes on stream together and all that stuff, so pretty good times those too. Those are probably more for like rewatching than I would say for watching it live and all that, so hey, you guys can go watch that too. Yeah, I think that's pretty good enough for promotion, right? pretty good for promoting the channel, right? I think got all, like, pretty much all the categories done, repeatedly telling you guys to continue to keep watching things over and over and over and over and over and over, and hopefully to make you guys eventually do it, so I will shut up. Telling you guys to like, comment, and subscribe, because apparently that helps the channel out. Yes. Alright, I think we checked Mark out of the boxes. Good. And all the people in Karlak's pocket, don't worry about that. Had a lot of corpses in his circle pocket. That's fine. Anyways, though. Inside a stream, inside a shrine, inside a stream, inside a shrine. I can't say that one. Inside a stream. I feel like I'm saying something else instead of inside a stream. You need the brainwash. Exactly. I still haven't brainwashed. Oh. Alright. One more thing. Watch the channel. See, this is why I need you guys here to help me. Because I can't. I'm trying. Just watch the channel. Support it. Go comment on every single stream that I have ever done. First person to do it. I don't know. You get a cookie. How about that? You get a cookie. I'll share my chocolate bar. How about that? I'll actually give up a piece of a chocolate bar for you. How about that? Your soul will never be claimed by Toka. Unless you want it to be claimed, then your soul will exclusively be claimed by Toka. Good. Alright, anyways. I did watch you go around. Alright, anyways though, let me go ahead and say thank you to those that were recently here. So thank you, Lord, for being here. Thank you, Tommy. Thank you, Saturday the Jinx. Thank you, Sylvester Inc. Thank you, Moises Sanchez. Thank you. Thank you, Electro. Thank you, Brand Man. That is as far back as I could see. Oh, and thank you, Killer was here. Thank you. Also, thank you, Osama. Thank you. And that's about it, as far as I can see. So thank you guys so very much for watching. Thank you. Thank you to those who are previously here before. And thank you to any of our Chris and thank you to my mom as well. Thank you. Also, thank you to those that help support the channel through Culture Roach. Thank you guys so very much. Also, through donations as well. So thank you guys as well for that. Thank you. But also, thank you to those that are part of the Tier 3 membership, which I believe is being Nathan Citrin, EH, Dazmaster, and Jackson Fox. Thank you guys so very much for helping support the channel. Thank you. Maybe I'll finally get a new mouse. You see the abomination that my mouse is. I'll clean it. I need to clean it. I need to go grab a wipe and clean it. I'll go do it right now. Anyways, guys, thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye!